Once upon a time, there was a young basketball player who had dreams of becoming one of the greatest basketball players of all time.
17 years old, with the hunger, the motivation, and a desire to be the best possible basketball player that I could be.
Toes and feels.
I have decided to skip college and take my talent to the NBA.
What's up, man?
Rest in peace. Mamba, R.I.P. Kobe.
Sense of purpose. No, a sense of purpose was there
real
since
legend.
I was a kid.
Rest in peace, man.
You know exactly. I felt like I knew what God put me on this earth to do. I just played the game of basketball. I just loved it so much. And once I came to the NBA and I looked around, I saw other guys that weren't working as much as I was, then I started to understand that, you know, how I went about it is hard work. Mm-hmm. To me, it was just, I just love what I do, so I want to do it as much as possible.
You know, now it's time to go in there, and it's time to do some work.
Can I, you know, look inside and say, okay, what was the genesis for me? Who inspired me to get to this point? You know, when I face adversity and I look at it as a challenge or an opportunity, where did that come from? You know, who did I learn that from?
Did you set goals when you started in the NBA? Did you have goals at that point? Things that you wanted to do?
Yeah, it was really simple for me at the time, which is win as many championships as possible. I want more. I want to learn this thing some more. There's got to be another level, you know? And it was just beyond exciting. When I step on that basketball court, man, I become something else.
Coming off the court, what emotions are going through your head?
Just pissed and sad, you know? Worked really hard to get to this point.
Bryant cannot continue.
Well, it's been tough, but you know, when I have tough situations, I try to look at them as challenges. I don't look at them as you know, something where it becomes a burden or something that's heavy on my shoulders. I look at it as a challenge and something that, you know, it's just a puzzle that you have to figure out no matter what.
Toes and Fields podcast. It's gonna be a crazy one. There's a lot of podcasts out there. It's gonna be your favorite one, and we ain't finna play with them.
Man, Fields.
Rest in peace, Cole.
Rest up, Unc. OG legend, buffed up and happy. You got your buffs this week on the Toes and Fields podcast,
Unc. That's them true pearly white boys too.
Got them angel white boys.
The angel tusks
with the halo gold.
Kyle, we gonna miss you, baby.
Man, that's fucked up, man.
What's so crazy? Me and Nephews were just talking about this shit last night with Unc, because LeBron just passed Kobe on the all-time scoring list, man.
Yeah. Congratulations to LeBron on that, but damn, man, we on, you know?
Yeah.
But as always, when we lose somebody, another king that we done lost, man. It's the beginning of the year. That's the first loss we done took. But on the Toes and Fuels podcast, we like to celebrate life, not more in death. So it's still a celebration. We about to celebrate Cole on the Toes and Fuels podcast today, man. I know everybody fucked up over this news, man. It really ain't synced in yet, but that's what we got this motherfucking pod for. We all gonna motherfucking come together.
Yeah, we gonna remember that man.
Definitely.
The Big Mamba, man. No, that was one of my favorite players, man, since I was growing up, man. Like, when I got introduced to really knowing about basketball, like, he was literally, like, the very first player that became my favorite player. You know what I'm saying?
Damn, Cole.
So, yeah, you know what I'm saying? That's like, if something, you know, so God forbid something happened to Jay, that's just how I would feel, that type of shit. Because that's like somebody I looked up, I actually grew up looking up to.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like when I played basketball, I used to say Kobe. I ain't never say Jordan. I used to always Kobe. Say Kobe. Kobe.
We done lost a lot of legends to airplanes and helicopters and shit.
Man,
cars and all this. I ain't never been on a plane, but what's so crazy, I was just thinking about taking like one of them helicopter dates and shit that they got.
Yeah.
Not no more, dog.
Oh, yeah. I know it's so crazy. My girl, like, fuck it, let's get married in Vegas. We gonna get married on off the helicopter. You know they do that shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
On his way to practice though.
Right.
A nigga died going to do the shit that he loved the most. You know what I'm saying? Because when he is, ain't he his daughter coach?
He was. Yes, he the coach of the team. Daughter team. And she was the player too, so, star player.
Condolences to the team that he was coaching.
And to Gigi, his family, his daughter,
man,
too.
He lost his daughter, Gigi. Can't even imagine that shit, man.
That's
definitely
crazy.
Want to send our condolences to his wife, man, and his other daughters, his whole family, man. And everybody else, all the fans, you know what I'm saying? We grew up on Cole, man.
Yeah. Everybody,
yeah, should touch home, man.
I got so many Kobe niggas, memories.
Niggas think they know Kobe, you know what I'm saying? That's what it, that's, well, what, that's why it hurts you, because niggas, they got emotional attachment to Kobe, you know what I'm saying? Growing up, you know what I'm saying? Especially like Mick said, Neff said. Yeah. When he was hooping, niggas used to say Kobe and shit like that.
Kobe?
You know what I'm saying?
Kobe?
Yeah.
What was one of y'all favorite Kobe moments?
My favorite boy? I remember it was him and T-Mac, and they baseball, basketball, back to ESPN, primetime ESPN. Him and T-Mac was balling. T-Mac made Kobe fall, but the next play, Kobe came and dunked out and smacked out on him. And I gave Kobe a tech, because when he dunked, he smacked the bat boy like, boom. I'm like, these niggas going at it. Like, man.
That's when he was with the Rockets, right, T-Mac?
No, this is T-Mac was like Orlando. Orlando days, when he was just, it was just T-Mac when Grant Hill didn't show up, when Grant Hill was hurt.
Man.
Yeah.
Shit, my favorite moment for Kobe was when they played against the Carmelo and them in the conference finals. When they said Kobe couldn't never get back to the finals.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying? It was game six. Ariza stole the ball on the inbound play. They, like, the last seconds, gave it to Kobe. Shit it on them niggas.
Mm-hmm.
We pulled up his shirt, you know, and that's Denver too. You know, that's when he had the case. Not he had the case, but that's where the case happened.
That's where the case happened.
I'm glad Nephew here right now and shit, because this is like Nephew favorite basketball player forever, dog. Like,
yeah.
Back in the day, when everybody used to be fucking with AI heavy and shit, Nephew always was a Kobe fan and shit. So.
Yeah.
Like I say, we was just talking about him last night when we was watching the game, the LeBron game. Because he passed them up on the scoring list, so it's just crazy how we spoke that shit up, man. That's the last thing I expected when we woke up today to see.
Yeah, definitely.
But my favorite Kobe moment is when he snitched on Shaq. What up, Unc? You a legend in heaven, man. You should have did that shit, though, man. Shaq, you fucking hoes too, dog.
Yeah, he was on some
shit. Yeah, he all cold for that.
He was on some bullshit for that.
It ain't just me, dog. That nigga Shaq like, damn, why they got me?
Fuck,
man.
Man.
All right, condolences to Shaq, too, and all his old teammates.
Yeah, definitely.
The whole world fucked
up. Yeah, we want to put everybody in our prayers right now.
So I was watching the basketball game today. They just showed the highlights on the screen. It was like, I think it was Denver. All the Denver friends was crying. You know what I'm saying?
How you ain't going to watch a basketball game and not think of, like, for real? Like, that's,
right.
How y'all think
Jordan feel right now?
Them niggas sick.
Everybody in the league fucked up right now.
How you think LeBron? He just passed.
They should have gave them niggas the day off, man.
They
shouldn't even make them niggas hoop today.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's Kobe, bro. Yeah. Most of the niggas that's in the league right now grew up. The reason they want to play basketball is Kobe.
That's
ridiculous, bro. Especially, I know Kyrie. Tatum,
all niggas like that. Say Kobe is idol. You know what I'm saying?
For sure, man.
Hell yeah, them niggas be practicing. Jason Tatum, all them be. He had the Mamba Academy on his second year, bro. Just imagine how many other younger niggas he would have helped. I mean, he probably still will. They still will, because they gonna have. I'm pretty sure they gonna still have that shit every year. It's probably gonna be even bigger, but you ain't gonna get the straight knowledge from Kobe. You know what I'm saying?
Right. That's crazy. Just making this transition into media and all that shit.
Won
a whole bunch of prizes for
that. I know he was coaching.
Y'all know where they was traveling? They was going to the basketball practice. His daughter passed away. Think about this, probably Kobe, he always takes this Calabasas helicopter.
Yeah,
every day. Kobe he's 10 in the morning, bro.
They say Kobe always take a helicopter. They say he was taking a helicopter when he was in LA.
Right, he live in LA. So, you know what I'm saying? He probably take a helicopter every time he gotta do something.
You know, LA as well, they got all those like private islands where you gotta take a ferry or shit like that just to even get to the island.
Right.
And shit. So he probably just like, instead of hopping a ferry, I'm gonna just fly.
Mm-hmm.
It's way faster.
Man, probably, that shit probably wasn't nothing. His daughter probably so used to motherfucking taking the helicopter.
Everybody used to that. He do that shit every day.
He probably do that shit every single time he got to go somewhere. Like
I said, Cubby was flying every day.
Right. Shit. He got that traffic. Well, he probably got to be places.
Pelican fly.
That's crazy, up, man.
I'm telling you, man.
It's always a risk with anything like that, dog.
Legends to that shit, man. Hey, Kobe LeBron.
Celebrate LeBron, my nigga Kobe.
You just Kobe.
Kobe.
Kobe, you just transitioned, dog. We about to celebrate your life.
Sitting here chilling with this rollie on my arm.
Came with a alarm. Be alone. I used to pay Kobe, now I pay LeBron.
Sitting here chilling.
It don't seem long.
When I used to pay Kobe,
now I play LeBron. Okay.
Kobe.
Kobe.
Until I pay LeBron.
Hey. Kobe. 24, 23.
Y'all niggas remember me.
Summer 02. Came doing that
white thing. They ain't know what to do.
They ain't know what to face. They ain't know how to act. I ain't even have a deal then. All let's keep it real. And while we at it, nigga, let's just keep it straight. Still the realest nigga hit it, homie. How you feel?
I'm feeling like a million bucks. Make me go to Foot Locker. I bought a million trucks. They say the club is off the chain. I'm on my Lewis shit today. Fuck some Gucci, man. These niggas still on my dick. They like some groupies, man. Can't keep their lips closed.
Don't you choose you, man. That ain't Jesus. Let you trick me
off these streets. You must be stupid, man. Man, I remember we used to be slapping this shit right here back in the day.
And then them boys slow.
What I paid for said it came with a law. Yeah, I'm trying to fuck, baby. Don't be alone. I used to pay Kobe. But now I pay LeBron.
Kobe. That's crazy. LeBron just passed him too.
That after.
23.
Y'all niggas remember me.
Call. Y'all niggas remember that. Money before rap. Niggas round my way. Call me Mr. Ben. Had a set. Them boys
man
in the hood. Call a nigga Mr. Bring it back. Mr. Go and get it anywhere. You know I keep a map. They say it's going down tonight. I hope I make it back. She say it ringing up tonight. You know I'm loving that. She say it's going down tonight. You know I'm fucking that. And ain't no shit to search me. You know I'm fucking strapped.
Oh.
All right, we ain't gonna do the whole shit.
That shit right there.
Yeah, it was fooling, though.
Oh, yeah, you know.
Big Hunk, man. So, like we said, since we celebrating his life, we ain't gonna mourn his death and shit. He put up 81 on Jalen Rose.
Killed him.
Detroit legend.
My Detroit nigga, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Killed young Jalen.
Yeah, he killed Jalen. He killed Jalen in the finals. I mean, Jalen Rose said he stuck his foot out to fuck his ankle up, that guy.
Yeah, he did.
He said he did that shit on purpose, too.
He said he always did that shit. He said he always trying to fuck Kobe,
man. Yeah, man. Shut up. Shit, he bust your ass. You got to do something.
Nah,
yeah. Yeah, Jalen Rose, what's good?
What up, Unc?
Yeah, Big Unc. Yeah, it's my favorite nigga. We said that on the last one, I think. That's my favorite nigga on ESPN.
Favorite analyst.
Good dude.
Hell yeah, man. But, what I was about to say, Kobe though, man. We need to just keep celebrating him, keep his family in your prayers, man. You know? And what did y'all think Kobe like best like top
I wanna
five,
know what the fuck
team?
Happened.
With
like,
the
how
helicopter,
the fuck did the helicopter
say a fire
go
broke
down?
Out. They say a fire broke out and then shit.
A fire broke out in the helicopter?
Yeah.
How the
how
fuck
though? Like that don't make sense to me, dog. That shit is fucked up when you think about it.
They got them little boxes and shit, don't they? Like the cockpit things in them helicopters?
Them black boxes. Got them in probably so.
Yeah, I think they got them in everything that fly.
Oh, okay.
Man, I'm pretty sure they had something
to see
like
what
that
happened while I go down.
That shit crazy, man.
Yeah, that is crazy as hell, man.
Them private motherfucking planes and all that shit, them bitches dangerous, dog.
Oh, yeah, hell yeah, because it's just you and the, you know what I'm saying? You know he a certified pilot, but a lot of niggas be having L's. You know what I'm saying? They really can't drive. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So it could have been anything.
But they say that motherfucker caught on fire though. So
the helicopter.
Male, yeah, whatever type of malfunction it was. Damn. That shit fucked up.
Hell yeah, that's crazy. I don't even know. Like, it's Kobe Bryant. He would have, I don't know what you've been thinking about. Like, well, that's why that's going down. Like, I don't know.
Probably, you know, if his baby is on there too, so you try to protect her. Like, you know, shit.
Cause I be flying a lot too. I ain't gonna lie. I fly a lot. I always think about that shit every time I'm on the plane.
Yeah,
but I always feel like, fuck it, God with me. That's how I feel it everywhere I go. And if, you know, I'm going somewhere, shit, I mean, fuck it. You know what I'm saying? Shit gonna happen if it's gotta happen. And I don't know what I'd be thinking about that type of moment when if it's actually happening. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right, right. Well, like I say, man, we gonna we celebrating this life. You know, our condolences. Yeah, it's fucked up. We about to fire up another L, I guess. I'm gonna take a shot. Y'all gonna take a shot for Neff?
Yeah, man. What about something? You got something?
Yeah, I think it's something in there.
What we got in there?
Probably some Jamie, some Hen, something.
Man, yeah, you definitely gonna celebrate his life though, man. He was, you know, very decorated in the sports, man.
Your nephew, you gonna grab one of them bottles out of there.
She was under that cabin. She was in there.
Yeah, like he had an Oscar, all type of shit, man. Kobe had a lot of shit, man. He did a lot of shit, a lot of all NBA teams. He gonna be a Hall of Famer. That was regardless.
Well, RP Cobb, RP GG, everybody else too that was on the plane.
Yeah, today,
condolences to their family as well. We don't know none of their names, but, you know, it's a tragedy. The pilot and, you know, whatever was going on, we want to send our prayers out to them as well. But we got to move on. So since we still on basketball, Charles Barkley recently was criticizing Draymond Green, saying he don't talk as much now that he averaging a triple single.
A triple single. You're averaging a triple.
Nigga having a triple single.
Who said that?
Charles Barkley said that about Draymond. You know what I'm saying? That nigga Draymond said, you make everything
Draymond been hurt, and plus they don't run plays for that nigga.
Yeah. Draymond said, Charles Barkley make everything sound like a Wendy sandwich.
Stained the shit out of a boy.
He make everything sound like a Wendy.
Triple single.
A triple single. He is funny. And he congratulates to LeBron too.
Yeah, we had a shout out LeBron.
He said a triple single.
Yeah,
triple
he flying dude.
Anything else on sports? Eli Manning retired. Man. Shout out to Eli. Y'all think he going to the Hall of Fame?
Nah, yeah, he got 2 Super Bowls.
I don't know.
Man, a lot of niggas ain't got. And he got 2 MVPs. Come on, man. He gonna go on his first try.
Yeah, I think he shouldn't go on his first try.
He gonna go.
I think he should go. Who? But do he really deserve to go? Is the question. He gonna go.
He got 2 MVPs. Hey, come on, man.
Both his dad and his brother in there. Come on, he definitely getting in that motherfucker.
It's Eli, man. He gone. First try.
That's a no Hall of Fame for me.
Yeah, that's a no Hall of Fame. To me, it's a no Hall of Fame.
Yeah, they're gonna put him in a hall. His name, then he won two Super Bowls, you know.
He beat Tom Brady twice.
2 Super Bowls MVPs, though. He's the only nigga to beat Brady in the Super Bowl,
I think. He do got 2 MVPs in the Super Bowl, but it ain't like his numbers was like right. Lit, you know what I'm saying?
He just more
he made,
so,
he made 2 good plays.
Who else did Brady lose to besides Eli?
Nick Foles.
Yeah, Nick Foles. That's who it was. And somebody else.
Somebody else got him?
No, he only lost 3 Super Bowls. He's been to the Super Bowl 9 times.
Who the third person?
That is Nick Foles. He only lost to Eli Manning twice in Nick Foles. He just lost to Nick Foles. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Not just, but the year before that. But he ain't in that bitch this time. Who y'all think gonna win the Super Bowl?
Obviously a great show, but I really don't care who won, but I'd like to see, I don't know. I got a bet on the Chiefs, but I already had a bet from early. So I don't really know, though.
Man.
I
don't see that
shit gone.
I don't know who gonna win it either, man. But I think the Chiefs might get them. I think they gonna try to get Patrick Mahomes to be that new face of the league. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he might.
Pop these shots for up. Let me see that bottle real quick in that field. Yeah, Patrick. Who y'all think gonna win the Super Bowl?
Yeah, that's what I just said. I said the Chiefs probably might pull it off, man, because they trying to make Patrick Mahomes the face.
I mean, they ain't got nothing to do with who gonna win, nigga.
That's why I think the Chiefs gonna win. I think he's going to be a close game. He the better quarterback. The 49ers got a better defense. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if the Chiefs can stop them from running.
So what we doing for the Super Bowl? Any Super Bowl parties?
Man, I wish I was in Miami.
Look at this rich nigga, man. This nigga got to relax.
Ace tried to get me to go down there, but you know the baby might come any minute, so I couldn't.
Say, man, I wanted
to go. Oh, to go down there to the
bar? Not to it. I just want to go down there.
That's
what
got. To the
they
down there.
Yeah. They, everybody just down there because it's football weekend.
That's my second like little shit right there.
You know, he love man.
That's his second home and shit. Nephew gonna move in a minute, man.
Not to Miami though.
We gonna be
it's gonna be a minute.
Yeah, Miami. That's like a vacation like, spot. You can't live there 24/7. That's gonna burn you
shit,
out.
Shit, I could.
Yeah, I could. Too.
I move to Florida. I move to California.
You ain't gotta hit the strip every day. But if you did, so what? Your whole life you just making money and just hitting the strip every day. I'll enjoy that.
You'll get burnt out on that.
Just to be on the beach.
Nigga, you burnt out here.
Right. You get burnt out on anything eventually. You'll
get burnt out everywhere.
I don't think I'm gonna be burnt out because you right there by the
burnt out by the beach.
You right there by the other islands. Yeah, that's the only way I'm gonna get burnt out. I sunburned or some shit.
Yeah, the only way
we. Y'all, we black. We gonna get sunburned.
Tanning, I do.
Yeah, you will, bro. I'm telling you. I thought I couldn't either, bro.
If you stay in the sun long enough, you definitely.
Your forehead,
will. Especially your
my
shoulders.
Forehead was crisp one day.
Especially your shoulders.
My shit was crisp one day, bro.
Boy was acting like he was Santana when he was out of town. Cuz already told me about nephew.
She thought I was Santana. Everybody kept calling me Santana. Right,
this nigga Jewel. He taking pictures of motherfuckers and shit. Like, nephew a fake ass. You live a whole different life when you're on the island.
No, bro. You take a lot of pictures,
nigga,
man.
He was taking pictures and shit, signing autographs.
Shout out to Santana, man.
He really like that nigga. Free Jewel, dog. Free Jewel, man.
It's my nigga, dog.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. I mean, why y'all give me this
that baby shot?
Yeah, man.
My bad, bro. I ain't
yeah,
no.
I feel like the nigga of monsters. Where he's like, yeah, I didn't get no whiskey out the deal. Shit.
All right, yeah. I was trying to wait for everybody so we could do this shit together for Cole. You know what I'm saying?
You need a lot.
Yeah,
so
we gotta go get another.
Nah, it's cool, bro. I don't need a lot.
I'm going off breakfast. I'm supposed to be going to the family shit, man. They like man, this nigga.
They like,
take care of
fuck with the family.
And nephew gotta go in a minute and shit, man. We just started this bitch. We tried to start a little earlier than we normally do, though.
So we did, though. We still did.
We got the banner and shit. Tools and Fuels. Y'all check out that good $2 bill shit.
Tools.
We got Blade on there. Call Me Young. Malcolm X.
Y'all, aka Detroit Red for motherfuckers who don't really know about
Detroit Red.
Aretha Franklin.
Aretha. Nuss.
You see John Rutherspoon, too. You see Pops on there.
Witherspoon on there.
Pops, I remember I met Pops in the elevator, man.
The first black person that ever been on money was on a $2 bill, on the back of the $2 bill. So we got him on there too.
We
got
to find out.
You learn something on the Tools and Fuels podcast if you listen. And we ain't get into our introduction. So
that was the overseer right here. He overseeing the black nigga to make sure the shit go down. Him right here.
Now y'all
live. He's the only nigga with the hat. Like, bro, that's the overseer hat, bro.
Telling you, bro, this hat right here, this nigga, man.
Yeah, he was watching. They had everybody watching him, man. Yeah. Come on, now you know what time. He
that's a nice
chicken.
Banner, man.
Oh yeah, shout out to Fresh Baked Prince. Yep. Support black business. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out. Thank for the backdrop. Thank y'all for that.
They did their thing with that bitch.
Oh, yes, sir.
Hold on, we need to do the motherfucking introduction, nephew.
Move.
Okay. So we lost Cobb and shit. We had to start it off. And pay our motherfucking tributes and salute to Big Unk, give him his buffs. But right around this time, it's still early, so you might, if you a queen, you might pour you up a little mimosa or some shit, get ready for your Sunday, get you a little glass of wine or something. Kings, take you some shots, man. Let's take some shots for Unk, you know what I'm saying? You ain't gotta go super hard. It's 5 o'clock somewhere though. On the Tools and Fuels podcast, you did. A lot of podcasts out here, but it ain't shit like the Tools and Fuels.
No, sir.
Shout out to everybody that been hitting that motherfucking subscribe button. Shout out to everybody that's been hitting the like button. Everybody that's motherfucking been fucking with us on Facebook, Instagram.
We fuck with y'all.
Hell yeah, we fuck with y'all.
Shout out to y'all. Aunties, unks, nieces, nephews. Yep. Roll that good weed. Cause we about to go motherfucking autopilot. Fly nigga shit, you dig?
Yup.
Hey, Quando Rondo. Double C's.
Yes.
We was broken, now we balling, baby.
Uh-huh. R.I.P. to Kobe, man.
That's a pick.
My son.
Take a shot.
I wasn't gonna even drink today, Cole, but I'm gonna do one just for you, baby.
It was fun, man. We got to.
To the Tools and Fields, man. That feels. To life.
R.I.P. Kobe. Tools and Fields. I'm not like the others, I'm way far from average. Call for my mama, my brother.
damn. That was harsh, huh?
No, that shit was smooth. That's for you.
Kobe motherfucking funeral might be biggest Nip shit.
Oh no, he you think Nip shut the city down?
Kobe about to shut the city down.
That bitch about to look like a parade. You know how they when they win the championship?
That Staples Center is about to be full like it's the game in that motherfucker.
Y'all think it's gonna be bigger than that?
Yeah, hell yeah.
You talking about the actual city?
Nah, are
you talking
funeral,
about like just the funeral? Funeral?
Oh, yeah, hell
Staples
yeah.
Center. He already filled that bitch up playing basketball.
Yeah, he about to. They about to, man.
Nah, Nip funeral was. That was Nip, a different type of shit.
It was different. Nip shit, bro. Yeah, that was very
Nip
different.
Nip everybody. Niggas coming from out of town.
Oh, you talking about?
And you know,
like,
Cole gonna bring niggas out too.
Bring out. Yeah, how many motherfuckers Cole gonna bring out? So many niggas. Cole gonna bring niggas from Europe. All kinds
of
shit, bro.
Yeah, you know, it's gonna be right. Yeah, yeah. It was a lot of. It was Kobe. It was a lot of. You know. Nip did it for a lot of hood motherfuckers. Did it for a lot of us. You know what I mean? But like Kobe, global. it's think about how many
Nip
had
Stevie
different races.
Shit, nigga.
Yeah. Kobe might have him. Yeah. Kobe gonna have somebody there
nah,
like
he
that.
He is.
We know it.
It's Kobe.
And this shit gonna be a whole
Aretha Kobe. Shit though. Aretha.
Yeah. That nigga run LA. Yeah, Aretha shit was crazy.
Yeah, Stevie or everybody at her
R.I.P.
shit.
R.I.P. Auntie. R.I.P. Unc. Witherspoon. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
She had all the presidents.
They said that Witherspoon shit niggas had a roast off, niggas still know roasting motherfuckers at
the shit out of one of my friends, nigga. You seen at his funeral though, they was saying like, I think who was up there? It was Sean Wayans. He was telling a story about when they were starting the Wayans brothers that they ain't wanna put Pops on the show. They tried to get who the fuck did they try to put on there?
It wasn't Pops.
It was I think somebody it was else Danny Glover, I think. I think it was something like that.
Oh,
it was like somebody.
Danny
Glover
probably
was
more popular. They like,
they like, man, we don't know. And they like, we fought to get him. Like, they were supposed to be on a totally different.
Yeah, they was going
to
be on a bigger network.
They
got Warner Brothers came out.
They like, we ain't even fucking with y'all if y'all going to put Pops on there. So, Shine and Marlon. Yeah. They went to WB or something?
WB, Warner Brothers.
Oh, they took it to WB,
Salute to them niggas too, man.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm
saying? Hell yeah, man.
It ended up being one of the greatest sitcoms
that's
of our
shit,
culture. Sure. You know what I'm saying? So, salute to them niggas seeing that shit early. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure.
But yeah, man. Kyle.
Though.
I damn near want to go. I did. That's
man,
some shit
I was thinking
to.
About it when it first happened on my way here. I'm like,
I know nephew want to go to that shit.
Definitely,
I do. That'll be some shit I'll go to. I'll go to that shit with you, nephew.
What? In Cali?
Yeah, I got on that shit with you.
That shit'll be so lit, bro. I get to see my nigga go close
yeah.
to the shit.
We ain't gonna be able to get in the funeral.
No,
but
we
at least be able to see. You know, they gonna ride. They probably gonna ride him. Yeah, they gonna
the
ride
whole
through
shit. The whole through the shit. Through. You know, he gonna be through all that. All around that bitch. I would have went to the Nip shit. You know, I don't really like going to funerals, but.
Nephew, what the fuck this nigga nephew doing? What the fuck is going
on?
He forgot
on,
how to
man.
Work the camera.
God
damn,
dog.
What happened, nephew?
Nigga, blow.
Yeah, man, so.
He used to smoking them Leroy's.
He definitely is. He like, what's going on?
C-Roy.
Got to breathe.
That's
good weed, nephew.
Yeah, take
you
your time, weed.
You got to get him
gotta
up.
Relax.
Take your time.
This nigga, man.
Yeah, but still, man. Yeah, that shit going to be, I think it's going to be crazy, bro. Like it's gonna look like when they win the chips. When they win the chips, the whole city, everybody be out to get down there to celebrate that shit.
Definitely.
Yeah, man. That's gonna be crazy one though, man. I'm there. I'm tired of seeing that shit, man. Especially with people like, you know what I'm saying? They don't feel like it's, you can't say it's not their time, but you just don't feel like, you know what I'm saying?
That shit was unexpected.
Like Nip, Kobe, that's 2 years back to back. L.A., they taking, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, LA been taking a hit.
You know, he wasn't really born there, but he from there. You know what I'm saying? That's just where he from. You know what I'm saying? Once you, LA, they take they niggas. They ain't really do that, though. They love Magic. They did Magic like that, too, but not how they take up for Kobe. They take up for Kobe.
Yeah, they love
tough.
Kobe, deaf, dog. They about to make a statue. Kobe about to get it. If he ain't got a statue yet, they about to make one.
Oh, he definitely got to get in the statue.
Yeah, his statue in the man. If it ain't there yet, he's already going to have one.
Hell yeah, that shit crazy. But they gonna be he gonna probably have all the people he gonna bring out is all like the basketball people.
Well, I think about Kobe, that motherfucker. He
owners,
a lot of hoopers, and
yeah, he gonna have it's gonna be a lot of bread in there too, just like all of them. He gonna probably have Obama, shit like that. You know what I'm saying? He gonna have people. Sure. He gonna definitely have the most people you can. Them the people be trying to talk to. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he gonna have a lot of prestigious people.
Prestigious.
Is that a word?
Yeah,
it is.
It was a well put word for that sentence as well.
Good word.
Yeah. I mean, shit, we try to make it to that. Oh yeah, staking on basketball too. Before we get off that, y'all want to talk about that Delonte West situation?
Oh yeah, we can say.
Oh yeah, that mental health, man.
That shit crazy.
You know, mental health is a motherfucking man. And,
yeah, man, Antonio Brown.
Yeah.
You see that they made him check himself into some type of mental institute.
Oh, they did.
With Antonio Brown.
Yeah,
after he got out,
bro. After they cut him and all that shit, he
went in there. He checked himself in with a suit, but under a suit he had on a track suit.
Right.
Under it.
Like, what? Boy,
they say he got CTE though.
Yeah,
bro.
But
they can never tell until he pass away.
Yeah, that's But you see, like the erratic shit he be doing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I think maybe sometimes motherfuckers might try.
Some
to
people be off. Some people
after
be
they
off.
Fuck up.
But Delonte West though, I remember back in the day.
Delonte really fucked up.
No, he been fucked up for a while. They say he been living like that. Niggas know you can find. They say you can find Delonte. If you live in Texas where you live at, they say you'll know where he at all times because he was like living under like some shit, bro. He like homeless for real.
Yeah, I'm Delonte East.
I'm Delonte East.
Shout out to me, you know what I'm saying? Delonte East. But nah, Delonte man, East, that's fucked man. Up with Delonte, man. Somebody even stumped him out. Had him on the side looking bad. But they say a lot of NBA people, I think Jameer Nelson reached out first.
No, he went to college with Jameer Nelson.
Yeah, so a lot of people been trying to, I guess they trying to get him some help, but you can't get no help unless you want to help yourself.
Yeah, man.
It's unfortunate for both of those brothers, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
We gonna be on the lookout for that shit.
Yeah, definitely, man. I seen them. My man's just kicking them all in the head, and Delonte West, man, he tripping, man. He out of there. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Bitch, I was watching this other podcast. I don't want to say the name of it, but they was talking about snitching on there.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And they were saying something like, if a police had planted drugs on you. Would you if is snitching on the police to snitching?
No. Maybe no. How was that? Cause they telling on you. And I ain't gonna say that, but they the police. Right. The motherfuckers they playing drugs on you. The police did this shit. This ain't mine.
Right.
And I wouldn't consider that.
But so to play devil's advocate, it was a guy on there that said a police is a street nigga with a badge. That's all the cop is a street nigga with a badge. Once you sign up for this shit, you signed up. For this shit. What you was gonna say now?
I was about to say.
Then I'm gonna have a lawsuit and everything down there, son.
Man, I'm you know definitely what I mean? Taking super legal action against the police.
Yes, I am.
I mean, I'll be whatever. It's the police. I mean, he the police. He motherfucking pledged to do some shit. You know what I'm saying? I didn't pledge to be street nigga. I just became, you know what I'm saying? That's how I would have felt about the situation. So hell yeah, nigga. And I can get some bread off of you playing some shit on me.
And you playing a game. You ain't even doing your job. You playing it on me. You know what I mean?
You ain't doing shit. Like what's your purpose of that? So you can get an arrest.
That's a snitch for you.
That's a no snitch for me.
That's a no snitch for me.
Somebody call it, man. What up, though? You on the Toes and Fields podcast? Don't say nothing crazy.
Yo, they killed my guy. The Illuminati killed my guy. Kobe, no, man.
We were just talking about that shit last night, huh?
Big up.
Yeah, well, we man, told you, man. They take out our black leaders, man.
It wasn't the Illuminati, man. You coming on this bitch with all them conspiracy theories and shit.
Who that?
Come to find out later on in life, they're going to be like, Kobe was doing something great for the African Americans. You know, they had to take him out. And you got that? You got what I sent you for that Malcolm X, right?
Yeah, you know, I ain't check it out yet. I ain't check it out yet, but I got the link you sent. I'm going to check that motherfucker out. I'm going to check it out a little bit later on.
Hey, they said Elijah Muhammad had sex with, he had babies by 5 different teenage girls. That's what Malcolm X literally said in his speech.
I don't believe that.
He said Elijah, yeah, he said it. No, they give video.
He wouldn't say that in no goddamn speech, huh?
Elijah
Muhammad. Like, when you having a speech, you ain't going to be, where do you fit that party in it?
I sent you the video link that showed Malcolm X saying Elijah Muhammad wanted to silence him because he found out that Elijah Muhammad had babies by 6 to 7 different teenage girls that was in his mouth.
Hey, for everybody listening, This is Uncle Sam's opinion, not the opinion of the Tools and Fuels podcast. Hey, that's to the nation. You know what I'm saying? Catch the nation listening to shit, dog.
This is just his beliefs, not our opinions. All I can do is repeat what exactly came out the man's mouth.
Oh, if it did, was shit.
I ain't worried about the nation at all because they had to deal with it anyway.
That was Uncle Sam once again. He worried about the nation, right?
Hey, what up to the nation, y'all, friends of the family.
Y'all in the family tree, Tools and Fuels podcast. What up, Farrakhan?
Yo, man, do y'all thing on the podcast. Y'all boys be right.
Yeah, all right, man, rest in peace to the Mamba, man.
Mamba, it's the Mamba cast. All right,
all right.
In a minute.
Yeah.
Man, he came on here with the conspiracy, everything.
Yeah, man, rest in peace to the honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Two conspiracies quick
fast
as hell.
Fast as hell, though. Like, black motherfuckers know. Kobe ain't been dead for 10 hours. Niggas turned into investigators already.
See how the
It's crazy.
They took him out, man, killed my baby, man.
Wait, they gonna niggas right now sitting down talking about that shit right now. I'm telling you, man, Kobe was about to, cure some shit, niggas ain't know, man. Behind the scene, you know, it's gonna be some shit coming out, man. Conspiracy theorists are gonna be doing some shit, bro.
Yeah, you ain't know what Cole had in the works.
Yeah. You already know. Every time, bro.
They say he's about to buy all the networks, man. Just how Bill Cosby.
Let his family get a chance to grieve and mourn the way they need to before motherfuckers start doing extra shit, man. That shit ain't even sunk in to us yet, for real.
Seriously, for real.
This shit ain't even really real to me, for sure.
Yeah, none of that was our opinion about Malcolm X and Elijah Muhammad.
No, it's not.
Straight up. I don't know what the fuck. Up, you tripping. But yeah, that's a no snitch for me. I ain't telling on the police. I ain't telling on nobody. You know what I'm saying? I'm just not telling, bro. But the police plant some drugs on me. Yeah, I just got to take that L, man. I done did so much shit that I ain't got caught for. Mm-hmm. It was just my time. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you gotta just take them bitches, dog.
This shit ain't mine.
I been say that shit too, like that.
If you say it ain't yours, it don't mean you snitching.
If he dies, he dies.
If you say it ain't yours, like you tell the public, like they be like, all right, we'll do what you
can. I know before that shit. I know before. First of all,
all you gotta do is prove it ain't yours.
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying?
I know they put me over. I ain't have it on me forever. The motherfuckers been looking for me to do that. That's what I did the shit. They knew they couldn't catch me doing nothing in the first place.
And so it's different if they look at the camera and be like, "Oh, he planted this shit."
So my lawyer had to try to handle the situation. For real, then why is his camera off right now? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Your lawyer eat that up.
Man. Of course.
Yeah, somewhere out there. Who got money to afford that? You see, they just been doing them stings.
They been catching a lot of niggas that been doing it.
First of all, if you ain't got no money for no lawyer,
ain't bullshit with no.
Why are you in the streets? If you ain't got no money for the lawyer, don't be doing no stupid shit. For real, man.
Yeah, for sure.
Who brought this
motherfuckers
up?
Motherfuckers' mamas be having to put their house up and shit.
Oh, yeah.
Just to get your ass out of there because you was trying to do some shit. You waited too long to jump off the porch and you was play pimping. Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. Michigan State playing Minnesota right now, whooping their ass.
Yeah, go green.
Michigan State, they some bums this year, though. Them niggas bums and everything. Like.
Nah, we straight. We be all right. Hmm. Still number one in the Big Ten, still, you know. We'll be all right, man.
Nephew, love Michigan State, man. No matter what nigga, he refuses to say when niggas is bum. So, what you think about D'Antonio? Is he out of here this year? They gonna fire him?
No. They would have got rid of him by now.
They already fired him.
So, he staying, huh?
He here till he retired. Yeah.
They'd have been dumb as hell to fire him right now. You know, they gotta do the scouting for the year to high school niggas and all that shit. Yeah, they like. Hey, spring about to come up, but yeah.
All right, so since we were speaking on mental health and shit, y'all want to talk about the Orlando Brown shit? How y'all feel about that? We were saying that shit about Orlando Nick Cannon.
Brown. Oh, man.
Are you talking about the nigga from...
That's all right. Yeah. He was on Major Pain, too.
Yeah, and he was on Family Matters.
He been bugging out forever.
That was 3J. I just seen him on Family Matters.
Oh, yeah, he was on Major Pain, dog. Yeah, he was. He's a little nigga.
Yeah, but look, that nigga Nick Cannon responded, right? And said he never even met him before. Then boy pulled up a picture with him and Nick Cannon together on that bitch.
I ain't seen the picture. We have to put that up on the screen.
So, hey, did that happen? Did that happen to y'all?
Hey, if I say he got a picture with that nigga, Nick Cannon
lying. Like, what you lying for, bro? If you don't know the nigga,
he catch you with a lie already. It's over.
You know what I'm saying? Just because a nigga on some crazy right. shit, that don't mean that nigga, he ain't telling the truth.
Hopefully Nick Cannon probably forgot about the picture or something. Like, shit, man, he was, shit, I he's walking down a red car.
Boy could just be spazzing.
He's probably on the same network.
They was. They probably was.
3J always had, he always be doing some shit. He'll pop up every
I heard him doing a little rap, though. He was freestyling. He actually got a little flow. That's just crazy.
Yeah, I think all the drugs been soiled his mind, though, probably.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure. That's why he's probably going.
He was doing drugs way before us. He was doing drugs probably way
he
back.
He was doing hardcore
you
drugs.
Just called Wayne. You seen all that shit they caught Wayne with? That nigga had hair. That nigga Wayne, he just got caught with some, like a pistol, ooh, some heroin, lean, all that type of shit.
Wow.
Yeah. He was overseas or some shit, though.
Overseas? Coming back from overseas or something. It was some shit. Wayne be blowed. I got a fact check. Look up that little Wayne.
Look up what Lil Wayne got caught with. That shit was recent.
He got that party pack. Party pack. Like, yeah. He got that good party pack for niggas.
These niggas be tripping.
He probably wouldn't. All that shit probably wasn't even his. He probably just had the party pack for whoever
wanted. Why that nigga got heroin? That makes sense now.
Right.
For real. That nigga Wayne, he been looking like crazy for
he's
a minute.
He's skinny as hell.
Even his dreads. Look at that nigga dreads, even though.
That's what the dog
you
do
gotta
to
think
you
about
dog.
It, bro. That's
the
what
dog.
That nigga
nah,
PG
it makes sense
on.
Why he was looking.
All them niggas, baby. All them niggas was on that yeah, shit back sure. in the day.
Dog to New Orleans, that's shit they do.
Yeah, that's huge in New Orleans.
Yeah, that shit. That's back in them days, man, you can't tell me he ain't do nothing all that shit before.
Oh yeah, but still, right now.
Oh yeah, that's what I'm saying. For him to be now, he grown. He old. He kind of old. He kind of older.
As hell,
and he rich as hell.
Yeah, yeah. Nigga, you can do what? You can do some other shit that give you the same effect as that.
Man, say so like, still on that
I
shit.
I want that dog for. I allegedly, because you know what I'm saying. Allegedly,
you said.
They say he about to drop an album next Friday too. Wayne, he's supposed to be dropping the album next Friday.
For real?
Yeah, rumored. You know what I'm saying? That's what they say. Did you find something?
You think he got himself arrested?
What did it say?
What did it say on there?
You think he got arrested? You think he got himself arrested, nephew?
Who?
Lil Wayne, because his album about to come out.
That shit took a long time
about. I don't know.
He did that shit.
Man. I don't be knowing, man. Because sometimes these niggas be the shit be happening to niggas, man. Like, they just be like, right before they album,
like
some shit pop off.
A publicity stunt.
Yeah. I ain't saying that, say though. He flew up to Miami
Monday night aboard a private jet that was stopped by federal agents. The letter found drugs and a firearm on the aircraft, according to law enforcement.
Whoa.
Yeah. Yep. I can believe that's real. Because them niggas, that same type of shit with Juice WRLD. Like, you can't be doing all that shit with them pilots, man. You don't know. You don't really. Let's they ain't your. It ain't like that. You hired your mans to fly you.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
That's why if I was rich, I'd learn how to fly. I'd fly my own shit. For real. I think who was that? John Travolta.
Yeah, one of them. Yeah.
It's a few motherfuckers.
It's
that
a bunch
fly
of people.
Don't Jay Leno fly?
I think them needs to be flying helicopters. I think Travolta do the helicopter.
Travolta do planes.
He do? It's Travolta.
Yeah,
I know he got an actual landing strip at his crib.
I figure if he can fly a helicopter, he damn sure can fly a plane.
Fly planes, bro. Yeah. He's a pilot.
I think it might be Nicolas Cage, though.
Nicolas Cage? I don't think so.
Yeah, man, too much credit for Nicolas Cage, man.
Nicolas Cage is doing a movie starring Nicolas Cage.
Yep, it's called Nicolas Cage.
About Nicolas Cage. And guess who's playing him?
Nicolas Cage. Face Off. Yeah, that's my favorite Nicolas Cage movie.
I watched the one movie with John Travolta on that. I think it was on like Amazon or something.
What?
He was playing like a mental patient that was like an obsessed fan for like movies and shit. The nigga was losing that. He actually acted kind of good in that movie.
Oh, John.
Other than Face Off, what else John Travolta had a good ass movie in? Is that it?
No, he had a bunch of movies. I don't know what you like.
Back in the day, he had Pulp Fiction.
Pulp Fiction.
That's what it is.
John, remember he had a lot of movies and shit.
Back in the day, he was a man. You know, if you ain't no real G, you can't ride the wave like Denzel. You know, everybody can't ride the wave like Will Smith. A lot of niggas rode that wave for a long time, bro. Mm-hmm. Even Nicolas Cage, he ain't getting, but he still getting money out here.
Niggas like
his own.
Like
he got his own shit going. He like independent. He getting his own bread. He still paid.
Yeah, that's John Travolta.
You know what I'm saying?
He be fine playing.
It was the photo.
For sure.
John Travolta.
Yeah, he living life.
The plane flyer.
But yeah, fuck it. Fly your own shit, nephew. Learn how to fly, dog.
Mm-hmm.
Feel me? You got to jump.
Yeah. Well, stop
it's the only way you know if you can fly.
Cause every time, man,
that's
them
a
niggas...
PSA from the Tools and Fuels podcast.
Cause every time, man.
Yeah, but I gotta get going, man. Nieces and nephews in the world, shit. Man. get to this family event.
You gotta get to this family.
They gonna be like, damn,
it's a family affair. You know what I'm saying? You gotta take care of that.
You gotta be over there, like,
especially with motherfuckers losing people so fast at such a young age. You gotta cherish the time that you're here, especially with family. So.
Sure do, man.
We're gonna let you get out of here, but we just gonna dock your pay still.
Oh man, shit, man, you gonna dock my pay?
Yeah,
man.
We still gotta dock you.
Dock
you. Yeah, you gotta take him off.
Yeah. Clock out.
Clock out. All right, now.
All right, my baby.
All right, now we running to you. We gonna keep the pie going though. You know what I'm saying? We gonna keep it rolling, baby. Yeah, so.
Yeah, for sure, man. So.
Even though Kobe passed and shit, man. Niggas mood ain't the same, you know what I'm saying? But
the pad.
We gonna keep it moving, baby.
Hell yeah. But shit, man.
What else we have for today? Put some music on or something, man.
What up, dog? You on the Toes and Fields podcast?
What up, dog? What's the dilly?
Can't call it,
what
man.
What up, Matthew?
So we're talking about this damn Kobe shit, man.
Shit fucked up, ain't it?
Yeah. Man. It's unfortunate.
Yeah. I was gonna tell you I'm gonna go over Flames crib. I don't know if you're still be
down. All right, that's a bet. As soon as we get done doing.
Or do you want me to bring your Joe on my way to the crib, or you gonna get out?
Oh shit! If you gonna pull up, I very pull up. How long you about to be over Aunt crib?
Shit, I'm gonna be over there for a little minute, probably though.
All right, well shit, we just call you when we finish, man. We got like another hour or so, 45 minutes.
All right, bet.
All
right, Toes and Fields. All right, that's Uncle Birdie, man. That's some niggery shit today. We gonna get a lot of calls though because Kobe passed.
Yeah, Kobe, man.
Everybody gonna be trying to call in.
Blowing the phone up, man. So we just gotta, you know,
let it roll with the punches.
Yeah.
They're like, man, damn, how many niggas called this nigga phone? He be trying to hear some music or something, man.
What up, though?
Put it on. Damn, I miss my dogs. My Lil Wiz. We just was talking about that nigga. That man.
Damn,
man.
Shit going
nuts, man. Hold on, nephew. What up, dog? You on the Toes and Fields podcast? What's up, nephew?
What's up, nephew?
Nephew. You talking about nephew? Kobe? Yeah, everybody baby. Know, man. Yeah, we know, bro.
That shit fucked up, nephew.
Yeah. See, everybody stunned by this Kobe shit, bro. Man.
Pull up. It's a mic here for you.
Still
nephew
going?
Just left. We still got like an hour left. Pull up. Bring a bottle.
All right, man.
All right, nephew.
Yeah, he said he gonna pull up and hop on with us. Hope he can make it.
Yeah, we probably be done by the time.
Yeah, that nigga. Say so he gonna pull up. All right.
Yeah, he gonna pull up. It's gonna be. We gonna be closing.
Shut it up.
Yeah,
put that Weezy on, man.
All right, bet it up, man.
We just talking about Weezy too. He blocked. So fuck it, put my nigga Weezy on, man.
Weezy, man, cut them dreads, bro. Them bitches is done it all, nigga.
Them bitches
hanging on by a strand of hair.
Man, them bitches.
What the fuck going on, my baby, man?
No, bro.
He still my nigga though, man. I just listen to the old music and think,
you still a legend. You still an OG legend, buffed up in heaven, Wayne. Don't get me wrong. We just don't like your dress, though.
Huh. Yeah.
And this album was a classic, too, man. Yeah.
Is this Wayne's best album to you?
Probably.
I think the second one might be. It's between this and the second one.
Yeah, to me. Well, you know, everybody say this.
I like the first because it was Manny.
That's the one with a Billy and all that shit on there.
Manny produced this one.
To me, that's the best rapping. He was at his best at rapping, but the songs to me was better on these two CDs.
To me, like better album. On these.
Yeah, I think the second album was crazy.
The third one, he was going crazy, but I think he rapped better on niggas.
Ready for
especially that second album. He in his bag on that second album.
Oh, he definitely in the second on his best second album.
That's probably the best one.
Yeah, that's the gotta
best
them.
Rapping one. Yeah.
Yeah, that shit right there. That's cold. That's what he called.
Got time to speak the history. I miss you and I know you missing me. Chisel, but then I miss my dog.
Mamba crazy, man. Shout out to Cole, man.
Everybody calling in about Cole.
And like, the baby. Baby Gigi, man. That shit so sad,
dog. Yeah, yeah, man. That's some real fucked up shit to hear, bro.
Alright. That was Wayne before. He was when he still had fresh dreads.
Yeah, that's when they was freshly nude.
Yeah. That was fresh dread, Wayne.
That's like when he first kind of got the dreads, wasn't it? Then he always had dreads when he first since he started. I can't remember though. Like that's the short dread, Weezy.
So what y'all doing for Black History Month, man? It's coming up.
It is coming up real fast, man.
Y'all got some Black History back.
Black History is the quickest month to go by too. So I hope y'all know that. So y'all better do something because it's gonna be gone real quick.
I remember it's one time. 4 weeks, 28 days. Probably like in middle school and shit, right? And we all had to. We had like I think it was history class or some shit. Mm-hmm. It was like February. We celebrating Black History. So we all had to stand up in front of the class and say a Black History fact, right? So everybody coming up there like, Madam C.J. Walker created the shit like that, right? This nigga Q ass go up there and say Martin Luther King had even haircuts. That was that nigga Black History fact, dog. Like,
yeah, this shit was crazy, nigga, dog.
Yeah, he wasn't lying. That's a fact.
Yeah, that's a fact.
That's a fact. You know what I'm saying? You had to get that nigga a good back grade in the day for that. Too. Yeah, you gotta get that nigga.
No Beijing, nigga. Yeah, you gotta give him at least a B. Yeah,
man. He said it how it was. Martin Luther King, and you know that nigga stuttered a little bit too. So he walked up there like, Martin Luther King had even haircuts. He walked off. I'm like,
even haircuts.
Even haircuts. I'm like, yeah, that nigga ain't lying.
Like, it did have a crispy ass cut, man.
It was some certain motherfuckers I couldn't be in class with.
I was just like, looking at some
out of that shit every day being in certain classes, dog. It was impossible to not get kicked out of.
Yeah, that's definitely real. Right, so I was looking at some pictures of Martin Luther King and his wife and his kids, man, when they was taking pictures, like had a little photo shoot. It just, you could tell, boy, he just had a different swag, man.
Yeah, for sure. We was talking about that shit last night. They was trying to make it seem like Martin Luther King was like a coon or all this other crazy.
Nah, bro.
Nah, brother. Never that.
Yeah.
Bro, you know, I watched like the Edgar Hoover shit and and some shit like the Uncover shit of Martin Luther King, man. He had like so much footage. All he did was listen to Martin Luther King like every day. Like they had so much footage. Like I don't wanna, you know, I ain't tarnishing my man's name, so I don't even wanna, but boy right, had swag. Right. Boy had
tripping.
Swag.
Boy was tripping.
Yeah, like yeah, let's let him know, man.
You know how that shit wasn't no cell phones back in the day. Right. It was way easier to move around.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Not as soon as you do something, is it?
It's right there. Right
in your girl inbox. Yeah,
yeah,
her shit be beaming, pinging.
You kind of, you can't do shit nowadays, bro. That ain't brave. Was cool. Like that, he was breathing around on the pod. Like,
but I mean, black men it? Don't cheat anyway, though.
Yeah, that's so. You know, I don't even. Don't know. Even I wasn't matter. Talking about that.
It don't even matter.
Hell no, man. Unless it's
But you, what y'all want to get into? Because we ain't talking about shit.
I'm about to say, what y'all want to talk about?
Some topics.
I want to talk. I'm about to say, look, you know, black men don't cheat unless you on falling from grace.
Ashtray, bitch.
Ashtray, bitch.
My ashtray, bitch. So, how you feel about that movie, man? Is that a stream for you? Would you watch it again?
Yeah,
did we all see it? Did you see it?
It was funny. Yeah, I seen parts of it. There's a lot of bloopers in there. It was funny because the bloopers had.
I know the whole gist of the shit, but I seen parts of it. I can't really watch. I'm sorry. I fuck with Tyler Perry because he built the compound. Yeah. He gave black people opportunities, but I really can't. I don't really watch this shit.
Yeah, I don't really watch this shit either, though, but that was like a different kind of like a movie. It wasn't the same kind of movie he made. You know what I'm saying?
He got a lot of backlash.
He trying to touch something different. You know.
That nigga got a lot of backlash for this movie. Well, he get a lot of backlash, period, the way he portrayed black women on screen. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he made her seem vulnerable. It was so crazy
when I was watching this shit with my OG before it came on. I said, y'all ready for this toxic shit? He about to make y'all look crazy again and shit. And what, to my amazement, Not to my surprise, but yeah, that shit was funny as hell. Ashtray, bitch.
Yeah,
that nigga was true.
But this shit like that out here, man.
No, it's not, nigga.
But at the end of the
day, it's a nigga kidnapping all hoes with his mama, and they taking all their social security checks.
Yeah,
stop it, man.
It's possible.
No, it's not.
I heard of a story of somebody they had killed somebody and took they kept taking their social they was cashing their checks and shit, but it was like a family member though. They own family member.
Man, if the mailman, we were so dumb about it. When girl went to the crib, the mailbox was full of mail, right? So it's like, why the mailman not gonna keep taking mail in that bitch if it's full of that shit?
Nah, he
so
gonna, he ain't gonna leave
the check there anyway.
Nah.
So how you even getting the check?
Cause they was coming to get the mail.
No, they wasn't. That bitch was full of mail, nigga.
They just ain't
when
been
the mailman
there.
Walked it's up to that week. Bitch, that ain't a week full of mail, man. That shit was like motherfuckers ain't been there in months. Mm-hmm. So what, they just going and just catching the mailman and just grabbing the check and walking off. Stop.
They going to get the shit they need, man. No, it's believable, man. Try to stop trying to hold my nigga Tyler Perry, man. Tyler Perry, we fuck with you, man. Give me one
nigga,
of them
moves. I fuck with Tyler Perry.
He trying to do it. He trying to get it in.
I don't fuck with him or her.
Of course, he trying to start it off. He trying to do something different. Now, of course, it ain't gonna be the best. But fuck
y'all
it,
put,
man.
I like different. Y'all put Oprah. He started something new.
Do y'all put Oprah in Tyler Perry?
Huh? I don't fuck with Oprah neither, bro. I just seen an interview with Oprah. She was taking her name off of that Russell Simmons documentary, but she not doing it because
fishy.
Russell Simmons. She was horn. Russell Simmons. I ain't gonna lie, but she like, it ain't a win for him. She like, but it was just some discrepancies in the documentary, and she asked him to redo it and take their time, but they ain't want to. They just ready to get it out, so she took her name off that shit. But I ain't fucking with. That's a no Oprah for me too, man.
Oprah
and Tyler Perry, they tight too, close like this.
That's what I asked. You know what I'm saying? Like, cause if you don't fuck with Tyler, then you kind of don't fuck with Oprah.
She cool with that nigga Tyler Perry making them kind of movies and shit.
Oh yeah. Damn, you know,
but she was saying get some more context. She was saying like she wanted more girls to be on the. She said they ain't have enough.
They
girls.
Have
she
a lot of actors. Period.
More
though.
Girls and all that shit on the.
His budget was tight for that one, man. He ain't have a lot.
Damn,
of
they said get more girls.
Tight.
They said we got to get more girls.
Exactly. That's what Oprah was saying. She like we wanted more girls. She like I wanted more girls to be on the documentary. To just I guess make it give it more clarity or some shit. I don't know, man. Some crazy shit. You could check it out. I think it was on like Good Day. She was talking to what's old girl? What's that everybody be talking to? Even the R. Kelly girls were sitting down with. Yeah. What's her name? Yeah.
Oh, that's our best friend. Yeah. That's who she put
that's
on.
That's who she was talking to.
Yeah, of course she put her
y'all
on.
Y'all can check out the interview. It's Gail and Oprah.
Yeah. You know, Oprah, like I'm only giving the interviews to Gail. I put Gail on.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't even know that.
Yeah, that's her best friend. Before Gail King, Gail King was not a journalist, bro. That was Oprah's best friend. You know what I'm saying? We only know Gail because Oprah. And then they separated themselves.
These motherfuckers be
coming. No, bro, they separated. That's how you know they good, though. That's how you know Oprah good.
Might have to hit a light or something in this bitch.
Yeah, it's starting to get dark.
The light now.
It's right behind you.
It's behind you. Just hit that bitch. No, it's behind you, nephew.
No, you get to put the band
on. Oh, hit the switch on there. Yeah, because that might be a little brighter.
This bitch straight right here. That shit should be straight.
It should be straight for right now. Yeah, leave it like this. Fuck it.
You know what I'm saying? But yeah, she put her own up. That's how you know they good, because they kind of separated. She separated for her for like 5-6 years, so you don't even know that they was best friends if you didn't know them before. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So now all she do is interviews. And she get all the best interviews. All
right, so Tyler Perry, he got like all these. Y'all been watching any of his shows? On BET.
I thought they was on Plus though.
Well, he got a few of them that's just on.
I fuck with the Browns. I used to fuck with the Browns when I was on and the Pines. Yeah,
you talking about the new ones?
He got
some other shit.
Think one of them called Oval. The Oval.
I'm trying to get on the show.
He ain't Tyler do
Perry,
Boomerang,
what up, my guy? Get me on the show, dog.
Tyler Perry ain't do the new Boomerang, did he?
I don't know.
Y'all ever seen that an episode of that? I seen like one or two episodes. It's kind of straight.
Where they come on?
He's on BET.
I don't watch none of that shit.
Yeah, I don't really like that shit either. The one nigga, the nigga, the Wire nigga, the nigga from the Wire on there, from back in the day, the Mikey, what's his name, Mike Wiles.
They need to bring the LeBron show back. Yeah. With that Survivor's Remorse, they canceled that shit.
Oh,
yeah.
They
used to come on.
They always canceled all the black shows.
They canceled Ballers. They canceled Ballers.
They killed off Mike Epps, man. As soon as they killed off Mike Epps, I'm like, what the fuck?
They probably couldn't afford to pay that nigga to Rock.
What he wanted. Yeah.
They like the Rock. Like, nigga, I need that chicken, nigga. But the way that Ballers ended was cold as hell, though. I ain't gonna lie. Now, that last season was cold.
He's my Ballers, yeah.
Yeah, that shit sweet. The way it ended was hard. They got one of the hardest endings on that bitch, bro.
The last season
cold as hell, bro.
I seen the season, though. Some of the season, I didn't finish it.
I know they was only gonna get like four, maybe four seasons, bro.
No, Ballers ain't one of the black seasons.
Did he get this Kansas City Chiefs?
How many they had? Five? Well, they had more than they was supposed to.
I know he was trying to get them niggas on that last season.
Did he end up getting them niggas? He did some crazy shit. Nah,
he ain't never hit the black girl either.
I think he hit her. We gotta watch it again. Yeah. I just know, nigga, that shit ended, the way it ended was cold as hell, because it was just basically showing like how fucked up all them NFL players was for real. He really was just fighting at the end of that shit. He like, man, all y'all billionaire owners, y'all don't want to give motherfuckers health care. Y'all don't want to take care of none of the players that's retired and shit like that. Like it got real as hell. He, you know, they got the real. They must have had the NFL stamp from that or some shit, dog. Because it was too many. It was real NFL players and that shit and everything. Yeah. Sue was in that shit. What's up, boy? Odell.
Odell.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a lot of motherfucking real NFL players in that shit. But yeah, that shit was sweet as hell. They need to bring that shit back, too. What else they just canceled? They canceled a lot of college shit, bro. Next season is Shameless last season. Season 11. Yeah, they read up one more season.
We did talk about that, yo. We talked about that before, yo. Yeah. Man, Shameless. Yeah,
that shit going on and on and on and on.
They got 11 seasons. That's what
they on season 10 right now. Next season is season 11.
Talk about the bag being secure.
Yeah, for sure. You know? It was still funny though.
Some of them niggas grew up. A lot of them niggas grew up on
they
that
grown.
Show.
They grown now, bro.
They changed the black nigga out like niggas weren't gonna peep it though.
How many times they changed them? I thought it was one time.
Just once. Yeah. We still though. They ain't the same nigga.
Yeah, like the first baby. Yeah, the first baby was different. I remember.
Yeah, yeah. They had probably, real. Yeah,
they like
first.
Fuck it. He gonna start making more money every time too. Every
he was too dark, man. They had to take him off.
What's so crazy? The first black kid didn't even speak.
You know what they do?
He ain't never had nothing to say.
No roles, no nothing.
Yeah. So now this new kid, he's smart as hell, though. He always talk. But yeah, that's a dope-ass TV show. What else good? That's on right now. 50 Cent got a show that's about to come out.
What's that shit called? I know he was
something about a nigga.
Shit.
It's on ABC. It's
Four Life or some shit.
Four Life or something. Yeah, for sure. Four Life.
For Life.
Did y'all see
where that's coming out on?
What's ABC.
ABC.
And it's called For Life.
I think February.
It's some hood maybe. Shit.
About a nigga that got locked up
and he got fighting to get himself out.
Before he got out. He was getting other niggas out before he even got out.
He got locked up.
Oh, he became a lawyer.
For some shit he didn't do. Yeah, and just started teaching himself the law.
Get the fuck out of here.
For real. And started getting motherfuckers out. He got another show about to come out. He just hauled Taraji.
Yeah, I seen that shit, dog. He hauled her. Taraji was mad as hell about that shit.
Yeah. I'm about to pull that shit up.
But that's 50, man. 50 always on niggas, man. That's what he do.
Cold. Everything you turn to is going to be cold.
Kobe, yeah.
The whole day we're going to be surviving around Kobe, bro.
Like it should be. Right. Yeah. We ain't going to never let the legend die, though, man. We going to talk about that nigga cold, man. Cold could never die.
Never, bro.
So it don't even matter.
But that shit was funny. He did kind of hold her and shit. She was mad about it, man. I mean, I ain't know how to feel about it either way. You know, I was like 50 just doing 50. But you know, he even take rap beef with everywhere he go. His whole life has probably just been like that. Like he still think he rap beefing and shit, even while he making TV shows and shit.
Yeah, well, I can't find any fucking shit.
Yeah,
but you think that's he bold he for always coming though. At? Why you think he bold for going at black people though? Why he won't do that to other shows? Like, yeah, this is us, this power, bitch, and shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he was basically saying some shit to her like, y'all show getting canceled this y'all last season, and I got the show that's about to replace y'all shit, some shit, some crazy shit he was talking.
Yeah, this Empire last season. I think it was on my sorry, I got my.
This Empire last season.
Yeah, I think Empire over, ain't it?
No, it's on a break. It's gonna come
they
back
did.
In like March.
They did, yeah.
It did. But this is their last season, though.
Okay.
How to get away with murder last season, that shit on the break is about to come back in this last shit.
I just seen the power. I know a lot of people probably just ain't seen that was leaked.
See the last episode?
I just seen the one today. This wasn't the last one today that came on TV.
I was about to say
they've been leaked them
check.
Bitches, man.
Yeah, I seen both of them bitches.
I'm gonna just watch them bitches when they come out, bro.
So the one that came on today is the one you seen too?
Yeah,
the one with Tate?
Yeah, I seen the Tate one, then I seen Tasha and Tyreek.
Okay.
Yeah. For sure.
But they said Tommy about to have his own show.
They showed some other shit. It's two spinoffs. They say the Power Book 2 Ghost is supposed to be like Tyreek spinoff. Because 50 got a spinoff and Old Girl. They got like a few spinoffs they doing. One of them gonna be on a different network though, and one of them gonna be on Stars. But I think Tommy getting his own spinoff. It ain't even gonna be the same as the Power 2 shit.
it's gonna be like Tommy on
Tommy shit. Yeah, for sure.
He's still alive.
I watch Tommy shit. For
I
sure.
will too.
If they I don't do know it if right. I'm gonna watch. I don't know if I'm gonna watch the other shit. But I seen some type of leak from some other shit, bro. When they was showing Ghost when he was a kid, nigga. They showed Ghost and Tommy when they was kids, and it was Carl Gallagher was playing Tommy.
Sure.
Yeah, as a kid, he was playing kid Tommy and shit. And they showed Angela walking up when they was still in high school and shit, dog. I don't know what episode that's from. I seen that shit the other day. Like, maybe that's off one of the spinoffs or some shit.
But
who the fuck be getting these leaks, though?
Man, I'm telling you, somebody getting
somebody
them.
In the inside.
Paid. It's somebody who they editing, bro. It's got to be a nigga who's editing, bro. Or he was somebody who the editor fuck with. He probably shot it to a nigga real quick, like boom, boom. Them niggas ain't gonna know.
50 said that ain't the real ending, so you gotta just stay tuned.
Yeah, he just trying to keep niggas
man,
in
that's the ending.
They said they had a chance. They said they had an alternate ending. The last time it got leaked.
They probably do got an ending, but nigga,
yeah,
that's the
remember
ending.
They had one when Kanan was alive, and they had one when Kanan wasn't alive.
Man, that's the ending.
They I believe have. You, though. I believe if you. That's why I asked you if the tape one was the same one, because if it was the same one, then that's probably all the leaks.
What happened? Said Entertainer was on there.
Yeah,
he got killed.
Shit, yeah.
All right, spoiler alert. My bad. If motherfuckers ain't seen that shit yet. Live and shit. I'm pretty sure everybody on Facebook has seen that shit already.
Definitely.
Definitely did.
Niggas done leaked that shit. If you haven't, you late as hell, dog. You getting your buffs next
year. I ain't seen, but every episode of Power get leaked to me because niggas be talking about the shit as soon as it come out.
Yeah, soon as
you
can't
go,
never
you
watch
can't
it.
Go on social media.
Right.
Trying to.
Watch Power and
yeah,
wait to
whatever,
that shit.
Whatever
yeah.
show that's popular.
Mm-hmm.
If motherfuckers that watch that shit, they gonna talk about it. Certain motherfuckers just love to just spoil the shit just to fuck.
They trolls.
Yeah,
fuck with everybody
just,
else.
Yeah, yeah, nigga, I seen it before you seen it, nigga. Yeah, nigga. Now when you see it, you already know what's about to happen. Get a life.
Get a life,
whoever doing
guy.
That shit, get a life, dog. It's
childish,
not that serious,
man.
Man.
That's why I was glad when I was watching shit like Breaking Bad, niggas weren't watching that. You know what I'm saying? For real.
I still ain't watched that shit.
You know what I'm saying? That's the shit, nigga. If you ain't ever watched that, anybody tuning in, fuck with it, man.
Breaking Bad, I always
the first
heard.
Season was
to,
like,
I remember it was
you
out.
Gotta get to the season
they
two.
They said that, like, that's the greatest shit ever.
Just start from season two. I tell everybody, just start from season two, man. If you gonna try to watch it for the first time, just start from season two, and then boom, you're gonna be going crazy. You know what I'm saying? Already. You ain't got to watch for him go from the beginning. You know what I'm saying? He goes, already be going nuts on niggas.
That's what I tell people about Snowfall. You want to really, if you never watch Snowfall, just watch season two.
Snowfall, dope as hell. That shit about to come back in the summertime, too.
Yeah,
Snowfall,
know.
The Shy.
Y'all seen they renewed
it,
for
The Shy, that's my shit.
Oh, the Shy coming back?
Yeah, they been showing the trailer. They got the trailer on.
My man ain't
still gotta watch. I still got to watch the second
how
season.
How they killed
Boy
off the
show? One episode off the second season.
Well, you know he was about to get killed.
How they gonna kill him off next year?
I think
year.
They showed he was dying. He down there died on the last episode of the last
season,
right?
So I ain't watch all the episodes then.
I mean, I don't think they showed him get killed, but I mean, you knew he was out of there.
Yeah, only seen the first episode, so I'm about to watch. I'm like, fuck it, that shit come back. I can binge watch that shit.
Yeah, for sure.
Whenever I watch shows, I watch like four episodes at a time. Anyway, I just finished Godfather of Harlem. You know what I'm saying? A couple days ago.
See, I only seen
watch the last
I only
three
seen
episodes.
Like, I only seen like four episodes, but they all was different ones. So I might have seen two, then I might have seen eight. So you know, how I watch them at the barbershop with Q. And
so we off the ashtray, bitch.
Yeah, the ashtray. That was the funniest shit on the internet for like a day or so.
Ashtray, bitch.
Yeah, that movie was funny to me though.
Sick, Nick. That shit fake, bro. That shit have never happened.
Yeah. Ashtray, bitch.
Yeah, he hit old girl.
No, older black woman I know is going for that.
Definitely, like, nigga say ashtray.
Black women, black queens, they got knowledge.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying.
But
when
he came.
Comes,
you gotta think about it. That's
wisdom.
That's just the movie.
You know what I'm saying?
He
wisdom
made a real desperate.
Man.
He made a real like vulnerable. Little real
young
desperate.
Buck. That shit was too obvious too. Like,
yeah, come on. He stole $375 from the bank.
Then what did he do with the bread though?
That's the same thing I was wondering. That's one thing I was wondering the whole time. Like, where the bread at?
He had a gambling habit or something. What was he doing with the money?
It's OG had.
But they was
then she dipped
they
out.
They crib was weak as hell.
Yeah, it
they
was
weren't like they was having, that wasn't no $375,000. Like he took $375, then he took some more shit.
$300. He's like $750 from her, from the bank. One from the bank, one from the crib.
Yeah, he took a loan out on her crib and shit.
I think
now, that's
crazy.
Possible.
Yeah, he that's married possible. Her and then take the loan out real quick. But you can't know what I really like that man, because you got to have authorization.
Yeah.
On the somebody account for them to
it's
authorize.
It's a movie, man.
Unless you add them to your shit, but it's hard as hell.
They don't be saying nothing, man. Yeah, they don't say nothing in a horror movie. When
that's why I ain't really, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, they do. Niggas talk shit. Like, niggas who really like horror movies, they be saying, ain't been no good horror movies coming out lately for real.
Yeah, it's a movie, you know.
Everything all right, but you gotta make the movie at least believable. But all right, it was a good. So you said that was a stream for you. All right, we off that lame shit. So fucks TV shows. We off TV shows.
That's crazy.
This Kobe shit gonna be all day. Nah, stop. Everywhere you look, that's on the game now.
I think Boosie in the city. I seen niggas taking pictures with this nigga.
He was down here last night. He probably had a concert or something.
They gotta Boosie. Be careful with my hood, baby. He like, I'm good. And
Boosie a real hood nigga.
Still got his ice and everything.
Boosie a real hood nigga. He like shit. He don't give a fuck.
Shout out to Nip too. That nigga, he went with 6 times platinum for the marathon. Six times.
Ching ching. Good bread.
6 million, you know what I'm saying? Meek, he got into a debacle.
I was about to say Meek, he go ahead, bro.
Y'all wanna talk about it?
Yeah, I was gonna say
Meek, was Meek scared?
I mean, it sounded like he was like,
I ain't even hear it.
He did say something about 1-on-1. You got the shit. You got this shit up. I can't put it on my shit.
I'll pull it up. I mean, shout out to Meek too. You my baby, man. I ain't want to talk about this shit, but it's a podcast.
Neff turn.
We don't want to be on no gossip shit.
Neff turn. Yeah, that's our interns. We call Neff turn.
Neff turn.
Neff turn.
I'm like, what the fuck? This nigga turning the channel.
Turn the channel now.
Turn Neff you so he.
Yeah, man. That shit to my nigga. That's crazy. That's conspiracy theory.
Fuck it, man. We gonna edit that part.
All right, let me pause it. She said it's 50 people outside.
That's Nicki Minaj, y'all. If y'all not,
Nicki Minaj's husband said it's 100 motherfuckers outside. I don't give a fuck. They know my vibe. Let's keep going. He telling Meek to clear this motherfucker out.
Yeah, clear this motherfucker out, nigga. Let's get your ass whooped up in here, Meek. That's what he said. Meanwhile,
he told Meek to clear that bitch out and talk to me 1-on-1. Meek said, you can't talk to me 1-on-1.
And then
he said, I know, nigga, because you pussy. He said, you a pussy.
Y'all ain't hear niggas stealing in the... Y'all ain't niggas here stealing in the background like... Bum, 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 all that shit going. Yeah, like 3 times. Bitch. Niggas was in that
niggas
bitch
still. Running out of that bitch with belts. Like, all type of accessories.
Hell yeah, man.
Cologne.
Isn't that bitch fooling?
That niggas ran about that bitch. Huh?
Yeah, you could have definitely heard it. I heard it 3 times, bro. As soon as it came on, then... Yeah, but shit, but Meek, man, he did sound like he ain't want no smoke.
And who was the other nigga?
Congrats. That's Nicki Minaj's husband. The nigga that went to...
She married already?
She might be. Is she married? I don't want to get it wrong.
That's her husband. Yeah, he went to jail and shit. They your blood. You know what I'm saying?
I wonder what the fuck they was arguing for, though. Like, man, I ain't about to be in the store arguing.
Yeah, they said they were just...
Oh, girl, is she with her nigga?
They said they just ran into each other. They said Meek was at that store. Then Nicki Minaj came. You know what I'm saying? Then she's talking about some he still want her or some shit. They was talking about he was still on that type of shit is what she was on. You know, she petty as hell. She couldn't wait to see the nigga for real. And with her husband. She right. Couldn't wait. They probably been wolfing for a long time.
Oh, yeah, you right. She saying that nigga can't get over.
That's what she was saying, yeah. That's what they were saying and shit.
Yeah, all right. We don't believe that.
Yeah, I don't believe Meek was on no shit like that. She just petty, bro.
Ain't Meek about to have a baby or some shit?
I think so.
Yeah, I think Meek about to have a baby with the Milano old girl who made that clothes, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That clothing line in Philly and shit. Don't quote me, though. Right. I think so, though.
Nah, I think she just mad because now he at a level where she was at when he first got with her, she was on a higher level than him as far as with the music shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Now that she under him now. And she see he about to get even more. Niggas is more anticipating his shit coming out like in the summer or something. Like they anticipate Meek shit coming out way more than that Nicki Minaj album or
that's some personal shit.
Yeah, super personal.
That's some other shit. It's something personal. Deeper than that. Yeah, just be honest. But we're just playing Meek, but you did look scared though.
Yeah, man.
I mean, Meek probably don't give a fuck about that shit. Yeah. Rich as hell.
Yeah, he probably ain't on that shit no more. She could tell she petty about that shit.
Yeah, so y'all get your buffs took, Meek, but that shit still funny as hell. What up, Meek?
So I give a pair of buffs to whoever was out there running. I stuck with them. They probably run out there with a pair of buffs, like, boom, 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 boom. Them niggas, whoever was there in that bitch with, that had to be like Meek or one of Nicki Minaj and them people.
DeShawn Jackson got a. He cops incredible Nipsey Hussle inspired Rolls Royce the 101. It's
blew out. I seen that bitch too. I did see that bitch.
Kind of rims it, dog.
That's his man's too, DeShawn Jackson. And speaking of Meek, do y'all think he gonna win the Grammy this year for the championship, best album of the year, rap album of the year at the Grammys?
That shit got nominated. Yep. For what? Last year? I thought that came out in 2018.
But it's the Grammys is like a certain time period. You know what I'm saying? It's a cutoff time for that shit. So it probably was in that cutoff time.
I don't know. Who are you know the category?
My shit. It's even good though to be even nominated, cause now they say not Grammy nominated, like increase your bag.
Get that shit behind your
name. Yeah, that should increase your bag. Or they'll say Grammy winning artist Meek Mill.
They always say Grammy nominated.
Yeah, even they always say Grammy. That's not, he's trying to get. You know what I'm saying? That's just for some his bigger bag. You know what I'm saying?
That nigga M, he the first artist with 10 consecutive number one debut albums in the U.S. Clap it up for him. Detroit legend buffed up.
Yeah, what up though?
That nigga album hard too.
Yeah, I fuck with him.
Man. It's just rap. It's just like you say, he rap.
He just super rap a lot on that. Yeah. Yeah. Like, we know you can do that. I just rather him scope better songs to me. Yeah, for sure. But I know he killing that shit. I know it's nobody making
Marshall, that and sure making shit up called. Together.
That darkness shit sweet, man. You know what I'm saying?
That Marsh called. My name was Marsh. That's what I played the video game. So I put that on. Nigga, I played the video game yesterday on that. Like, nigga, what? That nigga be going crazy.
What game you was playing?
Division 2. It's like a shooting game. It's kind of like a Call of Duty and shit.
Division 2. Yeah, you was playing on the PlayStation?
On the PS4, yeah.
I say YMW Melly facing death penalty in his friend's murder case.
What state that has to be, Florida or Texas?
I don't know. But
I think he was in Atlanta. I don't know.
No, I don't think Atlanta got no death penalty, do they?
What was the
so you think about being in them type of states, boy? You fuck up.
Maybe that's got something. DJ Screw coming out with a biopic. Yeah, I think it's gonna be on Netflix too.
That shit look cold too.
Scandalous. You seen the trailer?
Yeah, don't screwed up or some shit.
Yeah, it's called Screwed Up. That shit sweet as fuck.
All screwed
up. Be nothing about nothing but getting blowed, huh?
No, about him, how he started this shit. Yeah, it's his life story.
But no, they showing how he was from like the north side. The other day was beefing with the other side. That shit, that shit hard, nigga.
That shit look like that shit.
I just was looking at, did you see that Evolution of Hip Hop?
I did.
What's
that on?
Netflix.
I gotta get my Netflix.
It's on Netflix. It's a documentary, but they did the Super Producers episode. They went and seen Jay Dilla. They went to Memphis with 3-6 Mafia. Mm-hmm. They went to
them niggas definitely had super
Virginia
producers.
With Pharrell and Timberland and Missy. Mm-hmm. They came here with Jay Dilla. Mm-hmm. They went to Chicago with Kanye, and they was in Houston with DJ Screw on, like, they did like a DJ Boy. When they did the DJ Boy, that shit was hard as hell. They went to Manny Fresh. Manny Fresh, like, started bounce music down there, dog, in New Orleans, dog. His daddy was a legend. You know what I'm saying? I ain't know none of this shit for real.
Yeah.
They showed the whole story. That's a dope ass documentary, man. So if y'all ain't seen that shit, it's called Evolution of Hip Hop. They got like 4 seasons on that bitch, but this is the last
season. I
need
to get paid off all these little bounce songs. Mm-hmm. If he started that shit, he supposed to get a little 2% or something. He started that off shit, everything. Dog.
What it was, like, they used to all, everybody down there started rapping off the same beat. He made that song. It was some guys from New York, actually, who made the song. Mm-hmm. And he just took it and started, you know, mixing the motherfuckers in the club. Used to just be getting on the mic, just saying crazy shit over it. That's all they style was, you know what I'm saying? And then everybody just started recording. He had put a song together off that beat, you know what I'm saying? Made his own shit, and then it just popped. That's how that shit started doing it. But he was like, then they made another song. I think the first song he had ever made was some shit where they was just talking about, they say it was supposed to be like repping everybody hood, but they like, every time that shit came on, niggas used to just start scrapping as soon as that shit came on in the club. That shit, for real. For real, dog. That shit good as hell, dog. But it's called
Evolution. Niggas scrapping with that cup.
Yeah, it's just like they were saying everybody hood, and like once niggas they just should start going crazy in that bitch. He say every time that shit came on, niggas should subscribe. But that shit was hard though. Evolution of hip hop, check that shit out.
Yeah, definitely. That shit sound cool. I'm gonna have to watch that. I'm gonna give me some my Netflix back, man.
Yeah,
I try to say no to everything.
I had Netflix for life, baby. Netflix.
Netflix y'all heard got Dame Dash trying to start his own.
Hey Netflix, we fuck with.
He started it.
Yeah, he started. He got his own like a little.
I need my own Netflix show.
His own little shit like Netflix.
Yeah,
I heard about that shit, man.
They doing a tribute at the Grammys, or is the Grammys coming
tonight?
Come on tonight. Yeah,
it's probably like a little shit bullshit right now.
Yeah, for Nip.
Are you doing some shit early tonight? Oh yeah, no, they did say
they doing
Nip.
A tribute
YG.
For Nip tonight.
I knew YG
about to do something. You about to do something for Kobe.
Kirk Franklin, DJ Khaled, John Legend, Meek Mill, Roddy Ricch, and YG. I don't know. Is it live?
Damn, it's the Grammys tonight, bro.
Live.
Yeah, it's the Grammys. It's the biggest music award shit ever.
Say something about Kobe.
Yeah, and Kobe is it's in LA. It's the Staples Center.
What's
today?
January
24th.
Nah,
what's your date? 26. Yep. That shit come on tonight. Yeah. I don't know what time, but that shit damn near almost on. It's 5:00, 5:30.
Oh, I think it said it come on at 8:00.
Yep. It's at the Staples Center too. Dang, that's crazy.
Yeah, that shit is.
At the night of the Grammys too, on the day of the Grammys.
Yeah, that's weird,
yeah, that shit is crazy though, bro. Hell yeah, man.
Is that it? That's all we got on music? I want to play some shit? Ain't no music really coming.
I'm about to ask, did somebody drop something? Because I ain't see shit when I was looking on my Apple Music.
It was nothing, dog.
He said, like, it's. If you was a young, that's how you new artists, instead of just dropping when everybody drop, when it ain't shit that come out, that's the days you need to gotta find to drop your shit. When a nigga just pull your shit up.
Hey, where's Parchment Prison at?
Parchment Prison?
Yeah, Parchment Prison. Is that the prison that Jay-Z and Yo Gotti trying to have that lawsuit against in Memphis?
Oh yeah, I forgot. They do got a lawsuit. It's in Mississippi, yep.
Is that the name of the prison though? Because they was talking about Parchment Prison. It's supposed to be a rally. They had a rally and a protest at that motherfucker because they say it's so horrible what they doing to people. I'm learning many of the young people going in with non-violent offenses are joining gangs for protection because the correction officers have thrown in the towel. The prisoners had to wrap the dead bodies in sheets and carry them out themselves after they have been left dead for days.
Man, that.
Yeah.
What jail is that, man?
Parchment Prison.
I don't know what that shit is. Damn, we get that juice for him, I think. That bitch looked good.
Man, they're tripping.
This thing is greedy as hell, bro. Thirsty ass, man. Parchment.
Yeah, man, that's what's up, though, man. Change them systems,
yeah, Mississippi.
Man. Yeah, I knew I seen some shit about
that shit.
That's
that shit that Jay and them niggas showing, man.
Yeah. You talking about showing them?
Yeah.
In Mississippi.
They say, man, another inmate has died at Mississippi's Parchment Prison, making 8 deaths at the facility this year.
Damn, all right.
In 2020?
Yeah.
Need to do something about that.
Right.
That's why they on their ass. That's what I'm saying, Jay. Crazy. That's what I'm saying. But Jay trying to, he know, like, Jay came from that life, so he know he got a lot of people who went to jail, you know, shit like that, you know what I'm saying? So he, like, working for that shit, for the niggas that's in prison.
That's a lot of niggas, though.
Man, you gotta, they doing motherfuckers so dirty, dog, because right. That's like the forgotten.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, they don't care.
You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody like, going to check anyway on them.
They talking about non-violent offenders,
they can
though.
Do whatever the fuck they want to do to them motherfuckers.
Yeah, niggas don't be wanting to write. Up, niggas be barely wanting to write or anything.
Yeah,
they ain't answer the phone. So, yeah, I feel them. They doing a good fight, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So that's all I got on that though, man. I just wanted to put some awareness to that shit. Parchment Prison.
I forgot about that. I looked at that too.
Yeah, that shit crazy as hell. I remember seeing Jay-Z and Yo Gotti was suing the motherfucking prison, but I ain't know if it was that one. You know what I'm saying?
You say it was where?
Mississippi.
Mississippi.
Okay. Yeah.
So I think they got the death penalty too. Shit. You know all them type of states got them. You know,
all right, if you got 20 minutes left on Earth, right?
Uh-huh.
What you gonna do? Smoke or fuck?
Do both.
No, you can't do both though.
Oh, you only can pick one?
Yeah, cause you gotta go get the weed. The reason why you can't do both is
because you gonna have
you ain't got the weed on you, so it's gonna you got and I mean you ain't got no you got no woods or something. You gotta go get the woods and roll it up to end smoke.
Yeah. I thought you already had 20 like minutes. A blunt.
You gotta get it, roll it, and smoke it.
Yeah, you only got 20 minutes.
It's possible to make it happen, though. You can drive to the stove.
You can stay close to the stove. You got a chance of not getting to do neither one or go full away.
I might just already if I could just have my blunt on the roll, I just smoke my blunt.
I'm already saying, gonna smoke the blunt.
I just smoke the blunt.
So you smoking over fucking right?
Probably. I don't want to just die like trying to be like, oh, this nigga just a little horn ball just died out. Like
that's your last time getting some pussy, nigga.
Right?
What the fuck you talking about? Y'all niggas is some weed. Fuck weed.
I'm already gonna be high.
Nigga,
I know this my last 20.
You don't get to be high. Like, you was sober, bro. Quit trying to change the narrative. You sober.
If I can smoke with her and chill with her,
you only get to smoke.
I just smoke with her.
All right, that's what's up. Right, that's a it. Smoke for you. That's a what for you?
Smash. I got to get that last one in. Fuck that.
That's a no smoke for me, man.
Like, it depends on the scenario, bro.
Man, that is the scenario. You about to die, nigga, in 20 minutes.
We all know we about to die. She just like, come on, fuck, man. You know?
But I ain't trying to say the comment.
Just came and flashed on TV. Like, nigga, we got 20 minutes left in this motherfucker.
The comment hit the earth for 20 minutes. Bryce, it's over.
It's it.
Oh, yeah. I don't know.
You like, dog, I can either smoke or fuck, dog. What's my shit I'm about to do? Straight up, you know what I'm saying? Like, why you want to go out, get blown as hell? Like, damn, nigga, this comic, you go look at that bitch.
But you only got 20 minutes, so yeah, that's the only thing you can make happen quick like that.
Yeah.
Like, a nigga be like, I'm gonna fuck around, go rob a bank and all that.
For what? What do you want money for?
Yeah.
You can't buy nothing. There's nothing gonna be here, nigga. Not even you.
Niggas might just want to do shit just cuz. Like, they always wanted to do that.
I wanted to kill 17 people.
Nigga, you should have did it when it was a real risk. You know what I'm saying? It don't count. If you gotta do some shit with this. That shit don't count, man. You don't get no strikes for that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I feel that.
Man, you ain't no strikes.
But you know how niggas be thinking, though.
Chill, man.
Nigga about to go do, like, we about to. Now, if you had 24 hours to live, then yeah, maybe you rob a bank because you got your family and shit to take care of. But this is, nigga, the whole world is over, nigga.
In 24 20 hours,
minutes.
Though?
That old man shit?
No, 20 minutes.
Oh, no. In 20 minutes, though? Yeah, I probably.
Yeah, they were some hoes. They could have told us. They knew it was going to be over 24 hours ago. But they didn't tell us to the last dub. Like, man, it just flashed on all the TVs. Like, we could have told y'all niggas, but we didn't. But it's only 20 minutes left.
Fuck all y'all. No, I'm going to think it's going to be a conspiracy.
We on the moon with it.
Like, man, this is a conspiracy, man. Yeah, all right. So I'm gonna be sitting there chilling.
You gonna waste your 20 minutes? Yeah.
My 20 minutes probably gonna be wasted.
I just wanna be with my child. I ain't gonna be talk to him.
But
I smoke too in front of him.
I ain't smoking. I'm fucking dog. And we're talking about 20 kid. Minutes left. I'm gonna die in the pussy, bro. Fuck it.
Yeah, I feel
I'm going out like that.
It's they going out with a big bang.
So I ain't gonna bring out because I ain't gonna bring out with a bang. I want my son to be. I can't be fucking with my son in there.
You gonna be like, man, damn.
Man, why you can't? Shit is over.
So this shit
the
is
world
over.
About to end. He didn't know what's up.
No, man, I ain't gonna
chill.
Remember.
I just chill with them, man. I just smoke my blunt. Man. Let's get this shit over with, man.
I'll be like, look, kids, it was fun while it lasted. y'all better go play with your favorite toy, Nintendo Switch or whatever the fuck. This is the last time you gonna be able to do that shit.
This is the last time you ever gonna play with Nintendo Switch.
Bring that liquor. You said, no, I'm gonna keep this too though. Yeah, for sure. Whatever your vice is, you better do. That's your vice. You got 20 minutes to play Hello Neighbor.
You got 20 minutes.
20 minutes.
Yeah, for sure. But nah, man. I guess
that's silly, bro.
Because it ain't shit to shuffle.
Because I ain't even believe Kobe was dead until I seen, like, the New York Post did it. I'm like, damn, that's right. It's real.
Did anybody lose their bus? I started
saying ESPN.
No, it's crazy, dog. Nephew kind of bad luck, dog. I love that nigga, but that's nephew the nigga who told me Nip died, and he the nigga that told me Kobe died. We was just chilling at aunt crib. Nephew just looked on his phone like, y'all, that nigga Nip dead. He said it normal as hell too. Like, nigga, that's Nip. I'm like, what? I ain't even. I'm like, nigga, yeah, right. He like, man, Nip dead.
Oh yeah, I remember that shit. Yeah, so today, he just told you today, yeah, like, today, Kobe nigga, dead. He like, what?
Man, check this real quick. Make sure this real. They say Kobe dead. I'm like,
he like, man, what?
This nigga Nephew, man.
Kobe dead. This shit, like, bruh.
Kobe, you live forever, like we said, man, on the Toes and Fuels podcast.
Damn. That's crazy.
We never let your name die, nigga. We got to get some. Damn, we could have had Kobe on the backdrop. He ain't even from the D. But it's Kobe.
It's Kobe, yeah, man. At least put him over here or something.
You know, Kobe, we fuck with you.
Put him on the other side. This nigga
trying. Put him down with it. Yeah. Put him over here. Hey,
we can start doing
niggas.
That. Put him, like, put somebody, we can start adding people, bro. No, we don't want to do that. That might be bad luck. For real.
So,
add
niggas.
Like, put a face for Kobe right there. Just add on as we go. But that's bad luck, though, because we might start filling that bitch up.
Another shot for Kobe.
Big shot.
Hey, do I got this shit.
Shot for Cole.
That feel.
I just got a little eat in, you know. For everybody wondering what's going on when I was stepping off camera, I had something on my tummy.
But I don't think they was looking. They were like, fuck it, man.
And you know, I don't really drink Jameson, but I'm gonna drink something Cole today.
Shout out to Jameson. Shout out to the Bow Wow, bro. Let's go get you one.
This is Kobe's drink of choice.
Yeah,
we fuck with Cole drink.
This Kobe drink of choice?
Yeah, I think it was Jameson.
Man, see? Cole was a real nigga.
Cole. I fuck with you, Cole. That's fucked up. He got his own private helicopter.
He was rich, nigga.
It was probably like I think it's like it said it was a Calabasas.
You know how much money Kobe Bryant had? Yeah. It's Kobe Bryant.
It's like they whole community got like helicopters.
And he probably he probably ain't gotta pay for nothing there, man.
It's Kobe Bryant.
Five
bro.
Rings at that bitch, nigga. Anywhere he going, they just get that nigga shit for free, nigga. He probably fly the helicopter for free.
That's why he wanted to get Shaq up out of there. Like, man, get him out of here, man. He can't win five rings with me.
he wanted to show motherfuckers he could do it on his own. That's the same shit Belichick and Brady going through right now. Belichick like, man, I could do this shit without this nigga. Right. You know what I'm saying?
They just signed Brady to a 2-year something deal today.
They did.
The Patriots. Yeah.
2-year, $55 million or something, bro.
Shout out to Tom. He won. Look, yeah, that nigga Belichick can't get that nigga
Tom
out of there.
Brady. He like, man, I ain't watched coach. We ain't had nobody this year.
But they should have had somebody already there to replace him if they was gonna try to get rid of him. That's why.
Who, Brady?
Yeah, that's why Belichick was mad as hell. They got rid of Garoppolo. Yeah. Now that nigga in the Super Bowl
going nuts.
He would have. I bet you Garoppolo would have been playing for the Patriots this year, and then Brady would have been gone. If Belichick would have had it his way. At the time Brady won a championship last year, that probably would have been his last year with the New England Patriots. They would have kept Garoppolo.
That's for Unc.
Big shot for Unc.
Yeah,
that's too much shot for Unc.
Yeah, that might be the last one for me, Unc. Really?
All right, you ain't supposed to shoot that shit. That was a baby shot. He said you ain't supposed to shoot that shit.
That's some shit you said. Right.
That's not Jamie.
Fuck it, man. We gotta play some music.
Yeah, you gotta play some. We ain't really play none today.
What shit out? Y'all wanna play this new Yo Gotti shit?
That's some new God. Yeah,
he got it relaxed.
Who, Yo Gotti?
Yeah, Yo Gotti, my nigga, man. But you be tripping lately, Yo Gotti. Like, we get it. We like all yo singles. They been too predictable. Even though I like that shit with him and Lil Baby though. That put a date on this shit.
Yeah, that shit cold.
Yeah, that's shit
my shit right there. I still bang that. I'm put a date on. Yeah, that shit is sweet though. That's on this CD? Oh, this is like a mixtape or just a Lucy.
I think he about to drop an album.
Yeah, I heard this. Hey, we pull up like no version.
What up, Unc? You out now?
White, not all white. Look, all right. rich. Shout it thick. We fuck a friend together. That's my bitch. I heard you hit her raw. You taking rich. And she a thot. You with the shit. She a ho. Fuck the bro. She a secret. Just on the low. I ain't tricking at all. I ain't spending no dough. Don't catch me on no blogs, ain't linked to no hoe.
I'm Lolo.
So you gangsta gangsta. Hey, you applying pressure. She a bitch, ain't it? She too extra, extra. She that went viral, showed the world your text message. You had to block the hoe, cause she missing, missing. I'm a hoe, I know I'm a hoe.
I am.
But don't you call me that little nigga, that shit come with the smoke. I'm a hoe, got
bitches below. Shit, I think.
How many Instagram
models? This song personally?
Yeah, this used to be Ice Cube song.
Right.
I don't even know.
It is.
But
it's not my
own.
That's you be spicy.
Yeah, yeah, I know. He just thought it's the same beat and everything.
And the Houdini. Houdini, too. This Houdini really made this song.
Right.
Come on, man. Nah, this,
that's you got shot.
I like the beat, but I don't think they should've, he should have remade this one like this. Like, nah, yo, Gotti.
Come on, Gotti. What is you doing?
Yeah, not Gotti.
He made it for the hoes, though. The hoes.
Nah, I think he done went crazy when he did that shit with Nicki Minaj.
Nicki Minaj,
he made
yeah.
so much bread.
He like, nigga, you know how much that's gonna increase my bag again? Like, yeah, it's certain things that increase your bag. He know he probably not won't get no Grammy or no shit like that. So he needed ways to increase his bag every time he come out. You know what I'm saying? He get a Grammy nominee, his bag automatically gonna increase.
But like, why are you doing the Ha Ha Neighbor shit? Doing the rip rip, kill kill, trying to steal the I'm shirt sure. shirt.
Right,
cloth. He Debo, cause Debo yo, he is Debo, stealing your shit, bro. Run that.
Right,
yeah, that's
man.
A no stream for me.
That's some lazy shit, man. Stop being
that
so
personal
lazy.
Song is a no stream for me.
Yeah, yeah. Stop being lazy.
You know why I heard it though?
You can
no
make,
cap.
Come up with some original
some
shit.
Playing
if you
it,
go
man.
Flip some shit, at least like that shit was terrible. I ain't gonna lie, that's a no stream for me.
Yeah.
And my establishment
disappointed
me
with that shit, Gotti.
Playing
ain't
that
gonna
shit
lie,
through
man.
The hallway.
So
I'm like, man, who the fuck is that, Gotti?
But you know who flipped that beat to? Eazy-E and all them flipped that beat to. That's the one beat, Certified Gangsters.
Yeah, everybody.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure.
That's Certified Gangsters too.
Jim Jones. Yeah.
So you can flip that bitch, and you ain't had to do that version.
Bam,
you know what I'm saying?
Bam, yeah.
I don't even see nothing else.
He like, fuck, he done stole the whole verse. The song
man,
and everything.
The Stallion did some shit with Hell of a.
Hell of a year.
Man, that shit, man. It's, you know, it's for the females, man. But that's big look for Hell of a. So what up, though, the Hell of a?
What up, Unc?
The females was hot, though. Cause that song gonna be hot. Cause the hoes like
Detroit
that.
Detroit doing big that, shit, man. This year.
That Young Gotti song, they got the hoes gonna like, gonna be hot.
If you wanna play that, you can play that. That's for the women.
Play
they might like that.
Stallion, I don't wanna play that shit.
Dang, all right, I'm just saying.
Oh, no, I mean, no offense to you, Queen.
Yes.
But
yeah, you know,
ain't my cup of tea.
I feel you.
Yeah, but
yeah,
she got
you know,
flow though.
Yeah,
she can spit.
She really aggressive.
You know, Hella made
really
the beat at least. You know, shot my nigga Hella out.
All right, nephew want to hear it.
I ain't never heard it, so you know, maybe
really
niggas like, damn.
I hear you, nephew. It's called BITCH.
Man, we give him one a little half a spin.
Yeah, you know, get it like a good 35,
it's
40 seconds.
It's the Pac NIGGA.
It's the part the girls gonna be like on the podcast, like, yeah, I heard it.
It's the Pac NIGGA sample.
My bad.
You gon' call me when I'm trippin' anyway. You know you can't control me, baby. You need a real one in your life. The bitches ain't gon' give it to you, right? I'd rather be your B-I-T-C-H. Cause that's what you gon' call me when I'm trippin' anyway.
It is cause, though.
Can't control me, baby. You need a real one.
I like her flip better than Gabby's.
Yeah.
Right?
Why you wanna play with me? You know I'm undefeated.
But it's still lazy.
You know how to keep a nigga heated. You say you want respect, won't treat me how you wanna be treated. You told me to keep it real, but you don't practice what you preaching. You want me to blow your phone up and come and look for you.
What she talking about? Money back?
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
Fucking with if I find her. Bitch, you ain't that busy. I don't give a fuck what you ain't got time for. You look me in my eyes and know you lying.
Man, shout out to her for even looking at the
fuck
city.
Money back?
Shout out to Megan, man, for
yeah,
looking at the city, man. She knew she sees the Hell of a got to be. She requested Hell of a to do this song, this specific sample.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. She said, I want to do this song, but I want to have Hell. I want Hell of a to do it. She called Hell of a up.
Shout out to Meg for that. You got your bus for that,
you got
baby.
That bus.
So look, just for that, this is stream. This is stream for me, just because of that. And everybody in the city better stream this shit, because it's for Hell.
It's for Hell of a big deal. You know?
Hell, he one of the realest niggas still. He's super humble and shit. Bumping to him, be in a Porsche.
Yes, sir.
Big gun. Yeah. I say it's about time for to get that over now. That's a good stream. But you can't.
But the only thing that's Pac song.
You know it's gonna stream, and I'm you know it's probably like good.
If you do Pac, you gotta do Pac.
You gotta kill it.
Yeah, you can't be lazy. Like Meg, she talented enough to could have penned a better track for that shit. You feel me?
Yeah.
But it's still, I mean, you know,
it's hot right
it
now.
It is so. What it is.
Yeah, she probably like shit. That probably was hot to her. It's like a motherfucker.
It ain't for me.
For us, you know yeah, it's yeah. The females for love. That shit already like.
I got tired of the creator got out some new shit.
Darling, 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 there's no need to worry. It's just a couple things.
Is that him? How is they switching their voices up like this, man?
Mixing.
And they mixers is just amazing. Is that him?
I don't know. Give me the line. This shit called tell best him. Interest.
I can get your best interest.
This nigga holding the alligator.
Nephew done went back to work and shit. How you been feeling that work and shit, nephew? You happy to be back?
Nah, not really.
First you was ready to go back, now you ready to leave again. They ain't got your best interest here, dog. This year it's about elevating, leveling up. Whatever you aspire to do, do that shit. He was out here with a lane. I can play the side, make it roll easy.
I got a sneaker burning hard. I can play the side, make it roll easy.
Top of the morning like yeehaw. I took my shot, this is beatball. Nigga, the team you play for is seesaw. So I know that it's fake when I see y'all. Don't wanna fuck what you got up. I will never blow your spot up. I know my place, I'm the landlord. I can't read the weight to my hand, so we can't keep doing this. I'll keep it the best interest.
Yeah, musically, that nigga be putting some shit together, bro. That nigga do know what he
that
doing.
Shit was
hard. Yeah, that nigga know
that's,
what he
that's
doing.
That's a stream for me.
That's a new, some hey, new yo, shit that came out.
Yeah, like that shit called.
This is me. This is new shit he just dropped.
It's only two songs. That shit called Group B. The team I'm assembling, you trembling. We in a circle huddling, fumbling. We coming and tackling your empire. It's Robert crumbling. One nom, huh? Shit is humbling. I'm a fucking jumbotron, juggernaut. You a Jeep? No, you're not. New balloon, watch it. Concave on the skateboard. Don't do surfboards. I don't ride waves. Been around forever. Murray's pomade, nigga. Been like a decade,
Murray's palm waves. Hey, Murray palm waves.
I switch it up, you niggas don't. That's why you stuck. I needed seven figures. Hit Australia, pick it up. Find some young twink and get my nipples sucked. Bad yellow bitch, look like purple pus. Bad chocolate bitch, all
right, that's
look
enough.
Like Lionel Knuckles.
Fuck me up with that shit.
I pack like Louis trunk, luggage double C, Emirates double V, UT, but the sweater vest is me. Lemonade, elder flower with the world. Sony read up, I'ma spit it with the bro. Yeah. Niggas like, act your age till you trippin'. Pushing 30, but the skin say different. Well, if I act my last deal, I'm probably 12. I put some niggas on, niggas set up live, then they hurt they self. Niggas cheddar bob, foot is on the gas, I ain't letting off. Every car's gas, pissing Greta off. And they group B and the leather soft. And I knew the cow when he better off dead.
Toes and feels, baby.
Rest in peace.
R.I.P. Kobe.
Mambacast.
Way before it's time, you know what I'm saying? Since it's Sunday, it's only right we play some old school classics. So who else to hit him with? Then Marvin Gaye. I was going to hit him with the Stylistics at first, but. I see you out there, Auntie. We been seeing y'all in the DMs and shit off the first podcast. Y'all like, when the fuck these niggas gonna drop some more? We got them coming twice a week, nah. Had to get shit organized. Like we said, we celebrate Unc Life in this bitch, man.
Yeah, definitely celebrate Unc Life, man.
Kobe Bryant, gone too soon, my baby. Buffed up legend in heaven, died at 41, but he's still here.
Yeah, rest in peace, man. It's way too early, man.
And the baby, though.
And the child, too, though, man. His baby that he go out there and coach every day.
This might be one of the saddest. Like, think about it, man. This is. This is huge, bro.
Right.
Like, who we even lost? Like, Nip was huge. Pop, all that shit, right? But Kobe?
Yeah, Pop and Kobe. Like, Kobe, this shit gonna hit like... Yeah, like Tupac, Martin Luther King, or Malcolm X type shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, people felt those. That was real leaders. You know what I'm saying? Like,
hey, change that motherfucking channel, man. Put it on the real. Put it on the game or something. Something
on the real shit. The Rockets was playing, man. I don't know if it's still on.
Yeah, put on some NBA shit, man, so we can see what they talking about with Kobe, man.
Are you rolling up, Neff Turn? Are you doing? You got multiple rolls.
You gotta know how to roll up faster too, Neff Turn. Or we gonna fire you. You better perfect your skills.
And you gotta fix the live. Is the live still going, Neff Turn? Rest in peace to Kobe. Mambacast. You said it's done.
Bryant bench stop. Shout out 163 views. Shout out to everybody that tuned in.
Yeah,
to that
shout
shit,
out to everybody tuning in to the live, man. Appreciate y'all.
That banner looks so cold.
That shit do look crazy.
Yeah, we arrive.
We arrive.
You know what I'm saying? We arrive, man. It's all it is was hard work and preparation. But that's why I always give my nephews they flowers while we on the podcast, man. Life is too short to be complaining and beefing and falling out over little hoe shit, doing little hoe shit. Have some integrity, man. If anything Nip taught us, anything Kobe taught us, work hard.
Hard work.
Anything that you want, you can have that shit. But it's all about hard work, man. You gotta work hard, man. 1978 to 2020. Kobe Bryant passes away in a helicopter accident at age 41. Tragedy.
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 Tragedy. Yeah, man.
R.I.P. Cup.
Right after his last tweet gonna be the one to LeBron, congratulating him. You know what I'm saying?
Come on, nephew. You been having the shit on the timer?
Yeah, man. It's crazy, man. It's crazy, bro. That make people feel like, I'm pretty sure it's people who feel like I'm human, like for real, for real. Cause people don't concept death. You know, don't look at the concept of death. You know what I'm saying? Like that for real. They probably like, damn, if shit can happen to Kobe Bryant,
it can go any moment.
You know what I'm saying? It could be in his daughter. Like them, but they didn't wake up today thinking about that shit. And a lot of people don't be thinking about that to like.
When you wake up, you don't know that this is the last day that you're going to be here. When he got out of his bed this morning, he never thought this was going to be his last time.
Come on. If anybody on earth, bro.
Being in that bed in his crib, last time seeing his wife, last time, you know, he would have did shit a lot there. I'm pretty sure you would have just stayed in the crib. My nigga Kobe should have took the car, man.
Yeah.
Should have took the ferry, Kobe. Mm-mm-mm. Shit fucked up, man. Put that live back on, man. There's some shit we gotta be live for. A virtuoso. I was dead. That's what happened. Oh, okay.
They did my nigga call, ball as hell.
Thank you, my brother.
Yeah. That ball ass helicopter.
I wanna talk about
that. I had my nigga call riding in that ball ass helicopter. They say it was another parent, they daughter, and called his daughter. They said all together like 9 people on that bitch.
Man, that's fucked up. So they probably was just on there like,
it's a regular travel day. They probably always ride that bitch.
I travel with Kobe Bryant every day to practice with my daughter. Damn. You know what I'm saying?
They say we on a helicopter every day. We have
We gonna have to find out what happened, man. That, something don't sound right.
It's only reason why it's super weird to me. It's the day after LeBron passed that nigga up, and
right the day after. That's why it's just crazy.
He just was saying some shit like, "I don't mind passing this shit down to LeBron." Kobe don't talk like that,
right?
Kobe, and that was weird to me too. He was not to be on those conspiracy theory shit though. But sometimes right. They say people be knowing when they about to go, dog. That's what I'm saying. That's the reason why I'm saying that. Like, they say when you about to die, you know.
Right. Kobe coped with all that shit. He seemed like he knew because he been humble.
He got
over
with Shaq. He got over a lot of shit, bro.
With
his daughter a lot more.
Yeah, every day. Like, they go to practice. That's who he the coach. So, you know what I'm saying?
That's his angel now.
Yeah. And they together, but that's crazy. Yeah, man, they gonna get that man's statue at the front of the Staples Center, man. He should get the first one. Like, wherever this shit supposed to be, like, the best statue where that's supposed to be, yeah, you might as well put that bitch right there.
Yeah, that shit crazy, man.
41? Like, that's crazy. Magic can be AIDS, all type of shit, you know what I'm saying? Or HIV, or all type of shit, man. All type of shit. Niggas outlived them. All legend. Laker greats and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Damn. If I don't fuck, that's just me personally. I don't fuck with that. I don't even like flying, my nigga. That's always a risk.
Yeah, that planes and all that shit?
Yeah.
Man.
When you have one of that plane, it's always that risk.
There's can't be afraid to fly, man.
He can't be.
He can't, but shit, it's always that risk.
Knockout be flying forever, man. He got his wings. That's better than getting bust. You got your wings, my nigga. You and your daughter, y'all got your wings together. Y'all's inseparable. She couldn't have lived without you. And you knew you needed her with you. Y'all together. That's how we gonna look at that shit, man.
Yeah.
They got their wings, man. Like, I wish this day was just a bad dream, dog.
This shit don't even seem real. All the wonder and surprise
and the adventure I could be won. You're the one that I've been
You know Jack Nicholson ain't gonna be there. If I could, I'd let your falling star to shine on you so I'll know where you are. Put a rainbow in your favorite shade to show I love you. Thinking
write your name across the sky, baby.
That's classic right there.
Come on, man. It's for music supposed to sound like on a Sunday. Good Sunday on the Toes and Fuels podcast. Sorry it's so somber. We still celebrating. But come on, man. It's Kobe. It's sinking in more and more as we go through the podcast, too. You can tell. Say what up to Nip for us, dog.
Oh, yeah, man. You know, Nip was like, dang, Kobe up here with nah.
Kobe. I know y'all up there hoping. My nigga Kobe like, man, where the court at?
Yeah, you know, that's the first
and man, his daughter.
Oh, this Kobe can hoop again? He probably so happy.
Like he could hoop, yeah, hoop. Like
he got his legs and everything.
He like, nah, I can play the niggas that I. Then they, I can play some of the Wilt. I can play Wilt, yeah, Chamberlain up there.
Yeah, him and Wilt up there hooping together right now. He like, yeah, I'm here, nigga. I told you.
Oh, you thought I couldn't beat you, Wilt? Oh, you got 100, I got 81.
That nigga Nip and Pop, they over there on two different sides, uh-huh, betting against each other and shit, like Birdie on Bud the Rim and shit.
Hell yeah, Bud the Rim. John Singleton, he up there like, man, we should make a movie.
John Witherspoon up there chilling with them niggas.
Uh-huh.
You know Malcolm in that bitch.
Oh yeah, and Bernie Mac in that bitch too. They just making, you know, part
Bernie
two.
Got that bitch like a motherfucker.
Yeah, Bernie Mac on the Bud the Rim too. But they got Nip on it with Pac this time. And John Witherspoon on there too. You know they probably still do the same entertainment. They make movies and stuff probably still.
Chilling, man. They watching these niggas hoop right now. Like, mm-hmm, man, Kobe. Right now they having a celebration with Kobe, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That bitch. They got his wings and shit.
Yep. Baby girl.
They killed Dr. Sebi, he was teaching health. Fuck with Rick Ross, cause he teaching well.
Mm-hmm. Just lost another black king. I'ma teach myself. Young queen in the making.
All black Tom Ford. Special
city council. Everybody in LA right now too, man. We know how. That's Laker Nation. You know, they fucked up in LA right now, man. Everybody probably outside and everything. It's cold.
We was in the Regal, it was me and Steve. We done took a dream and turned it to a scene. Anything I wanted, everything I needed.
They say he love flying. He was on his way to go hoop. Died do it to his favorite things, you know what I'm saying?
Crazy, man.
Back on that shootout at the beach. Whoa. 20 deep. You tried to squeeze your gun jammed, and they released blood on your teeth.
It's definitely crazy.
How many stains? I see three.
Black color, man. That's panic,
so I made her switch seats.
Driving now.
Police chopper.
Head flying now.
Really not too spooked. Commonly ask me, am I dying now?
All I know is keep you calm and collected.
Cracking jokes like nigga.
Now you gonna be finally respected.
See your blood leaking. Got my foot on this gas. Toss the 40, we pull up to Daniel Free and see crash.
You know the alibi.
They start shooting, we was standing by.
Ain't see nothing but the flare from the talents fly.
I wasn't there, I was passing by. Matter of fact, don't say shit, I'm just gonna drop you in the back and slide. That's your weed, all the cash is mine. I take them both to the spot, plus your phone till you back online.
Crazy, man. Yeah, we literally talked about basketball and Kobe Bryant. I literally talked the last three times I was at Uncle. We talked about the basketball, bro. And we talked about Kobe Bryant. You know, shit was just last night. So one of them days was last night too.
And it's like every time you get to talking about a nigga, man, that's how it was with Nip. We were just talking about Nip.
Cause we be knowing something too, but we don't be knowing we know something.
Yeah, we felt that shit. That shit fucked up, man.
Man, that's just some that's how you know shit be unexpected, man. You just never know. You just gotta enjoy it. As long as you feel like you happy, and that's to me, that's the key. I'm pretty sure Kobe was happy. He was fucked up at the moment, but he probably was still happy with where he was at in his life.
Get what I wanted, I found a way. I had to sacrifice for this life. I found a way.
Switch my whole life
up. I found a way. It was so hard to get what I wanted. I found a way. I had to sacrifice for this life. I found a way. Got sick and tired of wearing the same clothes. I found a way. Got sick and tired of seeing the same holes. I found a way.
Hey, Vince, what up, though, my baby? Found a way, baby.
I'm going deck. You can come around the way. I got diamonds on the way. Ain't got time for no games.
shine like a chain. I'm on my mind, on my brain. From the grind came to fame. 20,000 in my back pocket. Sorry, nigga, I ain't got the change. Niggas that I grew up with hate me more than never. Charge it to the game. I just play the backseat, getting top while the driver switch lanes.
I don't know, that shit. That's nothing shit.
I had to get what I wanted, I found a way. I had to sacrifice for this life, I found a way. Got sick and tired of wearing the same clothes, I found a way. Got sick and tired of seeing the same hoes, I found a way.
Found a way.
Any drug, any plug on deck, come around the way. I got dimes on the way. Ain't got time for the games. Wanna shine like a chain. On my mind, on my brain. From the grind came to fame. 20,000 in my back pocket. Sorry, nigga, I ain't got the change. Run up on me, must be out your brain. You and I, we are not the same. Ain't say a word when the cops are came. Money coming, shit, you gotta change. Hardest young nigga out the game. Watch my aim, got 100 clips. Moving like I'm on the wanted list. I'm on a yacht with 100 crips. I ain't bitching shit, I wanted this. Jump out in Louis Vuitton. White teeth, black leather jacket like I'm cool with the phone. Fucking ring, kiss the shoe of a dawn. 100 P's, I can move them tomorrow. It was so hard to get what I wanted, I found a way.
Found a way.
I had to sacrifice.
Shit ain't easy out here, my baby. It's hard as fuck to get where you want to get to. But you gotta find a way. Sick of seeing the same bitches. Sick of wearing the same clothes. Don't hate us, dog. Hate your options. Hate your closet. Don't hate the Netflix. Find a way. It's all motivation, my baby.
Back pocket, sorry, nigga, I ain't got the change.
Nope.
Niggas that I grew up with hate me more than ever, charge it to the game.
Hey.
I just play the back seat, getting top while the driver switch lanes. Pull up new Maserati, I ain't touch a body, but the bitch came. 20,000 in my back pocket, sorry, nigga, I ain't got the change. Niggas that I grew up with hate me more than ever, charge it to the game. I just play the back seat, getting top while the driver switch lanes. Pull up new Maserati, I ain't touch a body, but the bitch came. I found a way.
Hey. That's definitely a stream for me. You dig? Find a way, baby. Play one more thing, then we gonna talk some more shit, then we get the fuck out.
Boss, let me talk to him.
Still got something on the list, man.
Man, you already been passing out our bus. Ain't anybody seen any movies?
Fuck ducking drug enforcement. Trying to turn my niggas to dumb bosses.
Grammys.
Put them in position, become bosses. Writings on the wall when spitting, I hung portraits. Way spinning, I'm dumb nauseous. You got a few sitting, I want more of it. Never take the first number to judge office. I'm in the Gucci store
right under the Trump office. Is you living or you existing?
Gotta start living, can't be resisting. No matter how you get it, just be persistent. Consistent, from not becoming statistic. Realistic, no lie. I'm at these niggas next and I'm gifted. Bow tie. Claiming you the best, what you sniffing, bro?
High.
Sugar Ray Leonard, it be hitting like no moss. Ha. Shame
on the nigga
that
trying to run game on the field like we ain't gained the game from a nigga.
Ready to cop back and aim on the nigga. Dropping the top back in the rain on the nigga. Rims bending the corners, bad bitches is on us. Breaking day with the hitters, hit dirty kitchen the morning. Breaking haze in the swisher, that pippy having me on it. Niggas claiming they with ya until it's raining and storming. That fake shit, smile up in your face shit. Get around niggas and always saying some hate shit. How you been eating? They never hand them a plate shit. Always see you speeding up down the block in the spaceship. Hoodie on big fit, my blood on his ape shit. Clipper go bananas on any tree that he shake with. Fez in the cameras, they trying to peep every pavement. Move like Sopranos, we only speak in the basement. Check my bank statements, why I stay patient. Niggas ain't playing, be careful on who you play with. Huh, you think shit a game. Got stopped by police, gave a different name. Had my OG give me different game. Before my face was on the piece of a nigga chain. Wish y'all could feel a nigga pain.
climbing out the hole like my nigga Bane.
Got a condo, crib and Wayne. Nothing around but mansions. Got me feeling strange.
Going crazy, late 80s, and I'm still insane. From the streets, if you listen closely, you can hear the train. My man got me vexed like fuck a friendship. Throw 80 at a nigga Mercedes and watch the Benz flip. My coach told me I was a loser and wouldn't win shit. Now I got twin chicks on my dick begging the French kiss. Still got my gym star, deflate all that gym shit. Buck 50, work your face out, permanent grin shit. I used to keep a negative vibe. Was on some Grinch shit. Skimp a little work off the top.
I had to pinch shit.
I just got off of jail, call an hour long. Feds be listening, so we kicking it with the shower on. These niggas acid, I'm cocaine in powder form. Watch his body drop, then we pulled off, knocking Quiet Storm. Yellow butter soft, I'm feeling like Ike Love. Everybody pull up with chopper, shit like a bike club. Lately, I just come up with this shit, ain't gotta write much. I'm focused, niggas with no direction to fuck your life up. It's orchestrated. How the fuck these niggas afford to hate it? Smoke with the dead, I might walk inside a morgue and blaze it. These are scriptures, all my verses are more than sacred. It's levels to this, you ain't never heard no Porsches racing. You ain't never been around no bitches that's more than basic. The coke weak, don't trust the plug, then you oughta taste it. Put it on your gum, see how quick it numb. Your bitch stress, she keep telling me about how quick you come. When I think of the illest, I figure big and pun. Put a fork in them, this nigga done. Go get a gun. Fighting ain't like you, confused. Why would they hype you? Nigga, you Ron Harper, out here acting like Michael. This what the life do. My past women spiteful, but fuck it, we got baking soda. Let's see what this ice do. My man, he just got his house. I'm about to send a kite through. Don't come around, I ain't invite you. I used to do more with gators, them shits will bite you. Don't nobody touch no money
till the dice move.
Just keep it tall.
Nobody touch no money till the dice move.
Bitches talking about Davies from London to Edenwall. I ain't scared of death when I sleep. Me and the Reaper talk. Fresh out public housing, this life is better than we'd have thought. I want you off this earth and we don't need to talk. Same rules apply, baby. She ain't fucking and she can walk.
That's a stream of y'all.
Yeah, I've been heard that,
nigga. I know, but I'm just saying, it's a string.
Yeah,
right.
It's been a string.
Yeah, it's old, all right, nigga. But everybody, all the listeners haven't heard it before. I gotta shout my nigga Votto. That shit called The Hate It from Votto and Dave East. Shout out to Votto, too. He got a whole bunch of new shit. He been going sick. I should have played some of that shit. Mm-mm-mm. Y'all wonder what Uncle Steve and they had to say about Kobe?
Did this happen? Yeah, of course. It's about his newest shit.
You already know he's
information
right now, brother.
Kobe, he's the greatest.
It's just devastating. Obviously, I found out a few minutes after the reports came out. And, you know, it's a guy I've known for his entire career. And I've known him pretty well. And we've talked a lot and throughout the years. And knowing what a winner he was, not just on the basketball court, but off of it. How inspirational he was, how motivational he was in terms of really helping to instill in other people, you know, just the tenacity and the focus on being all that you could be, never taking any shortcuts, a willingness to put in the work, to rip yourself and shred yourself of the excuses and the things that hold you back from achieving the things that you aspire to achieve. It wasn't just about basketball with him, it was about life. And that Mamba mentality wasn't something that was reserved for just basketball players or for just athletes. It was for any human being out there who had a dream, who felt the need to be inspired about something, who wanted something so badly. It was about going out and getting it. And he was just that kind of guy. And he laughed a lot more than people realized. He told a lot of jokes more than people realized. He'd sting you whenever he could because that was his way. He was a guy that, he was a great basketball player. He was a great father. He loved his wife, and that's obviously tremendously. He was a great friend. We were just together on New Year's Eve, and we were supposed to meet again in a few weeks to discuss some things and to just hear the news that he passed away, particularly in this fashion. He's been taking a helicopter for decades, living in Newport Beach and, you know, flying, you know, toward downtown to L.A. to the Staples Center, you know, to and from games all the time for many, many years. He loved being in that helicopter. He certainly was never really concerned about it. And for him to be gone, particularly through these means, is incredibly tragic and is sad. And to know that his daughter was on the helicopter with him, it just resonated even that much more profoundly. So obviously it's incredibly sad for me, incredibly sad for the NBA community, and it's just hard to put it in words, to be quite honest with you. That's the best I can do.
You know, Stephen A., Kobe Bryant's been a public...
That's crazy.
Everybody, if you turn on TV, man, that's all you gonna see. You know what I'm saying? Man. Jerry West just wrote a long little, what you call it, excerpt.
Statements.
Statement.
Yeah, he definitely a Hall of Famer. He definitely.
Oh, never forgot.
You know what I'm saying?
But we was talking about movies. You seen, y'all seen Bad Boys 3?
Yeah, I seen it.
All right, I haven't seen it, but
yeah, I seen. I seen Bad Boys Sleep.
Oh, it was a.
I went to sleep.
It was a little, to me, it was a little Tyler Perryish.
I went to sleep. I went to sleep on like three scenes.
I liked it though, but they just did too much and too much. Like, if you ain't seen it yet and you don't know nothing about it, then I ain't gonna say nothing. Cause you gonna have your, I'm gonna let you for your own opinion.
I mean, nah, we gotta talk about it. Just cause
I went to sleep on it. I'm good. Three times.
I went to see. He said I went to sleep three times. Oh, now
every time I actually came.
In a minute, you gonna be. It's gonna be nephews and an aunt. Look, last night we was talking shit, right? When niggas did the first nephews album, not to go on a tangent, right? But niggas did the first nephews album. I wasn't on it. You know what I'm saying? So when it was time to do the second nephews album, this nigga nephew was feeling himself so hard. He said this shit got to be called Do-Ride and the Nephews. Oh, I ain't doing it.
It's time to re up.
This nigga went David Ruffin on these, dog. She got me called Do Ride. He went Ray J. He went Ray J.
I don't even remember that shit, bro.
We had to kick him out and shit.
Yeah, that's how he got kicked out of Netflix. He just got brought back for the podcast.
And then he dropped his own album and shit.
Yeah, it was hard.
He had a sweet ass solo album. We see why he was trying to do his own shit. He had the whole.
He was feeling himself hard as hell. He left the nephews. He did his own solo album and shit.
Yeah, I remember that shit. That shit's funny as hell.
Yeah, I don't even remember that shit.
But yeah, nah.
I told y'all niggas that he called Do-Ride and the Nephews.
Yeah, so this shit gonna be
because he was in high school.
And the Nephews in a minute. Because y'all see, y'all ask, oh, no.
Because at the time when Nephews 1 was done, we were still in middle school at the end of the year of middle school. That's when I first, like, kind of came to Roosevelt. We were just in that motherfucker. We was in the middle of doing, we was at the end of doing Nephews. But yeah, you know what I'm saying? Then he held us.
Nephew was on some true. Who a motherfucker that just kicked everybody out of shit? Nephew was kicking everybody out. He like, nah, you out of here. He kicked Nephew out. He kicked the other Keon out. What up, Keon?
What up, Nephew?
I remember y'all was about to scrap in the middle court. Of the court. That nigga B walked over there like,
y'all brothers, man.
Come on, man. Y'all niggas is brothers, man.
Nigga, ain't that nigga brother?
Nephew the most quiet nigga, dog. But this nigga crazy. That nigga like, this ain't my brother, nigga. I'm like, man, that ain't his brother. You know me back in the day too. I'm like, yeah, that ain't his brother, nigga. Fuck that nigga.
Yeah, that was my nigga though. Yeah, he was still my nigga. We just mad at that time. You know what I'm saying? Then he moved and shit, man. Right after that though.
Yeah, he like, man, I ain't got no more friends here no more, man. I don't got nothing left here. You got the fuck on. Then some tragic shit happened to him.
Man.
Yeah, shout out to Keon.
Look at these niggas. They don't even want to hoop.
What happened? Yeah, man.
For COVID. They took the court. They just took a stand on the court for a minute.
Yeah, probably. It doesn't even look like it's enough players out there.
They did it around the whole league.
On the first possession, they don't do nothing, huh?
Oh, okay. That's hard. So on every first possession of the games today, they just
hold the ball, take the whole 24. That's the Mamba, 24 shot clock.
Yep.
Tribute cold,
for the
bro.
24. That's hard as hell.
It's going to turn to 24. It'll turn back to 24. That's what I like to see, man. The Mamba. That's when the Mamba was born, though. He said the Mamba wasn't born until he turned to 24.
That shit crazy, man.
That was like almost kind of later in his career when he was really in his prime.
But yeah, I seen we can get into Bad Boys first. What y'all think about it? It was some bullshit.
No, I think it was good. Like, I liked it, but it I just heard was a lot
of people said it was good.
Yeah, it just is a lot, man. He
it
had
was too long. They had too many like down scenes. They could have just took out.
Hella action in that motherfucker too.
Yeah, though, action woke me up. I liked that. You know what I'm saying?
But man, shit, man, they Mike Lowry supposed to die and all type of shit, man. Man, that the way they
yeah, nigga pulled up on him. Me, yeah, I wanted to say the whole thing, but yeah, ain't died, but the way that boy got him, he's supposed to die. I ain't gonna try to ruin the movie for other niggas, but
niggas ain't seen it by now, nigga. Yeah. We can ruin it. Say spoiler alert.
As long
right
as
now,
he don't care
turn
about
it off
saying
right
it,
now.
Yeah,
it's a spoiler alert right now. So yeah, we gonna if you don't want you haven't seen the movie yet.
Boy ran up on him with the Uzi, man, sprayed him.
His own son, Mike Lowry, had a son from a bitch he fucked in back in Puerto Rico 25 years ago that he never knew about. He put her away in jail. Mm. So she was like a part of a cartel.
Yeah, it was his son at the end.
He was his son. So
he ain't know it was his son neither though.
He didn't know to the end, but he was smoking everybody though. That nigga sweet. His son cold as hell. His son sweeter than Mike Lowry.
Do y'all see Hidden Gems?
Hidden Gems? I want to see that. Uncut Gems.
Uncut Gems.
Yep,
I'm waiting for that one to hit Netflix.
That's what I want to see.
You seen that?
Yeah.
Oh, that shit cold.
I'm waiting for it to hit Netflix.
Did I? Nah.
You should have waited.
I mean, but the way that they shot it is cold.
Okay.
Like if you like shit like that, then you might like it. But
I might like it then.
Because it's super real. It's like a nigga got a gambling habit.
Yeah.
And it's super real. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. Put that.
It's long and drawn out, dog. I ain't gonna lie.
It's gonna be on Netflix.
It is though.
Yeah, it ain't good like that.
Okay,
right.
I'll definitely
you
catch that for free.
Yeah, you gotta wait till it comes to Netflix.
Yeah, I'll catch that free.
It's gonna be on Netflix, so you know. Yeah,
that's some shit I think you should wait for. So I should wait for Bad Boys. Don't go see that shit at the movies.
I mean,
Bad Boys. Ain't
if you ain't
Netflix.
Seen it by now,
the,
I mean, it's gonna be amazing.
The day that Bad Boys came out, I went and seen Uncut Gems.
Oh,
she was there. Yeah, I could have got tickets to that. But I'm like, we like, man, fuck. I wasn't excited for
everybody already had seen it. That shit was boring and long anyway.
No, that's the first day it came out. But I just never was excited for it. You know what I'm saying?
I wasn't either. It's way too long,
it's
man.
It's a long movie.
No, I'm saying it's way too long from when they made the first one, the second one, and the third one. This shit is way too long, bro.
But all the young niggas like, yeah, we ain't get to see Will. So then they was like, yeah.
That shit was.
He said he didn't even see it.
When I seen it, there was a lot of young people.
I'm saying
in
it
there.
Was too much, bro. They did too much. They ain't, the first one is just still. If you can't top the first one, they might as well stop doing that shit.
Yeah, I was never excited.
Yeah, that shit was childish. Will Smith, not Will Smith, but that nigga Martin that ain't funny like that no more. Like, man, what's up, man?
Yeah, Martin, man.
Them niggas old now, man. Them niggas probably.
Yeah, that part of the little funny, though.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, he just probably just trying to get a couple more bags, and he like, fuck this shit, man. He on tour though. I thought he was coming to the D too. He got a whole list of niggas. Like it's called Lit as Fuck Tour.
Oh yeah. I did see that. I wanna go to that shit.
Yeah, y'all going to that Mike Zepp shit this year? That shit on
No, I ain't going. After last year I ain't going.
What happened last year?
Remember the little stud? The little stud female. Peace my man left.
Peace who?
Why that's gonna make me
some big guy.
Scared of stud?
Nah, it's just, man,
scared
it's too
studs.
Much.
Nah, he didn't want to go out.
Nah,
the studs coming out. He bring the studs out.
Nah, it's just,
Flame,
man.
I think
it's
Flame.
That was the last straw, man. It's always some ratchet shit. Every time Mike Epps comes to the D, it's always some ratchet shit, man. That was all the last straw.
Y'all wanna see some funny shit I was reading?
What?
All right, y'all know the song, Ice Cube, Good Ass Day, right?
Mm-hmm.
They were saying someone actually discovered exactly which day Ice Cube, Good Day was on.
Man, no, let's hear this. I got to hear this.
So look, so hold up. You got to rock with me. It's a little long, but just rock with me, right? All right, clue one. He went to Short Dog's house, and they was watching Yo MTV Raps, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yo MTV Raps first aired on August 6, 1988. That's clue one. Mm-hmm. Clue two. Ice Cube's single, Today Was a Good Day, was released on February 23rd, 1993. All right, so the first clue was Yo MTV Raps first aired August 6, 1988.
Mm-hmm.
Second clue is Good Day was released on February 23rd. That's my daughter's birthday. Shout out to Gabby J. What's up, Boo Boo? Boo Bear.
February
1993. Clue three, the Lakers beat the Supersonics, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's a date between Yo MTV Raps aired date
August 6, 1988, in the release of the single February 23rd, 1933, where the Lakers beat the Supersonics.
On February 23rd?
No, I'm saying that's between those dates, between 1988 and February
23rd. Okay.
All right, and this is all the
times the Lakers played the Supersonics.
Okay,
all right, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, November 11th,
1988.
Okay, November 11th, 88.
All right, the Lakers won 114-103.
Okay.
November 30th, 1988, 110 to 106. April 4th, 1989, 115 to 96. April 23rd, 1989, 121 to 117. January 17th, 1990, 100 to 90. February 28th.
They always beat them niggas when they played them then, huh?
February 28th, 1990, 112 to 107.
No, they only just showing the
Lakers wins. Yeah.
March 25th, 1990, 116 to 94. April 17th, 1990, 102 to 101. January 18th, 1991, 105 to 96. March
24th, 1991, 113 to 96. April 21st, 1991, 103 to 100. January 20th, 1992, 116 to 110. These niggas didn't went crazy, yo. Whoever did this shit, dog.
The Supersonics. That's look, Magic beat them
niggas every year.
That's Magic in them.
This shit because it's so long, but they I'm already them. In.
This Magic pass. Against Gary Payton.
Hey, hold on. Anybody that's watching this shit, if I put y'all to sleep, like, you at work right now, you like, damn, what the fuck is this nigga
just go past
about?
The numbers now.
Don't be able to get the clue shit. No, but you need this is a clue. So maybe you can rewind it. All right, clue four. Dates of those Laker wins over Supersonics where it was a clear day with no smog.
Oh, yeah, he said that shit too.
Okay.
November 30th, 1988. April 4th, 1989. January
18th, 1991. January 20th, 1992.
January 20th,
1992? Yep. All right.
They beat them January 20th, 1992. I'm damn near sticking with that. That's the last one. But keep going.
Got a beat from Kim and she could fuck all night.
So when did he fuck Kim? How did they got that number?
Beepers wasn't adopted by mobile phone companies until the 1990s.
1990s?
Dates where mobile beepers were available to public.
Okay.
Alright.
90s? So it wasn't none of these days in the 80s. Boom. There ain't wasn't no beeper there. Alright, let's go. Keep going.
Alright, hold on. Let me find it.
We need to dinner kind of play that in the background.
All right, January
18th, 1991. Yeah, put that
January
on
February 20th, 1992. That's dates left where mobile beepers were available to the public.
Wait, hold on, that's beepers over here?
Yeah.
Hold on, and that was January 28th?
No, January 18th, 1991. Uh-huh. January
20th, 1992.
92, okay. All right, Ice Cube starred in the film Boys in the Hood that released late summer of 91,
uh-huh.
but was being filmed mid-late 1990. Early 91, Ice Cube was busy on set filming a movie
January 18th, 1991. Too busy to be lounging around the streets with no plans.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the only day where Yo MTV Raps was on air, it was a clear and smogless day. Beepers were commercially sold. Lakers beat the Supersonics, and Ice Cube had no events to attend. Was
January 20th, 1992.
Nephew got that shit.
Man, I knew it, dog.
National Good Day Day. So every year on January 20th.
What was that this today? That was Martin Luther King Day this year.
National Good Day Day, baby. Them, whoever did this shit is like hip hop nerve.
I like that, man. That was good, man.
That shit was tight, though.
I got that shit, too, dog.
You got it, man. This nigga smart. My nephew smart.
Hey, man.
Yeah, for sure.
Thanks, man. I appreciate you.
Hey, man.
It's Sunday.
You never heard.
Damn.
Thanks, man. I'm tight. I needed to get that.
I know. I'm boosting your account.
Thanks, man. You keep this shit going.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can read.
A little bit.
Yeah.
But I ain't really read that. I kind of sloppy chicken scratch.
It's all good. You did that fast, though. You wrote that shit fast. So you could be one of them motherfuckers. What they call them?
Arbitrator. Yeah, I was say practitioner.
The motherfuckers that be at the in court typing fast as hell doing all that shit.
I can't remember. Comment that on the under low.
Yeah, tell us what it is. I say arbitrator. I know that ain't the word though.
Comment that down below.
Down below.
You heard that Roddy Ricch song before?
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah. Bob Evans down on the farm.
I don't know why that just came to my head.
Y'all seen that dang dash in the room?
Yeah.
Breakfast Club.
Yeah, remember that's how I was saying. Remember I was saying.
What he was saying
about his Netflix he got.
Oh yeah.
He got something on Netflix coming out.
No, he got his own like streaming service.
Yeah, it's like Netflix. He wants
all his own original content. That's enough stream for me.
Oh, so he doing some shit like
he never dropped nothing. Yeah.
So he trying.
He dropped Paper Soldiers.
So basically, he trying to do something like. He trying to do something
that's
like
good. I'm saying it's better than a lot of other movies.
All he
got
to do is get niggas to sign with him.
It ain't all good like do that.
Get niggas to sign. He like, yeah, he can sign.
He got an eye for talent though. He put Kevin Hart in there like, yeah,
you
know
never know, right. Bro. Yeah, he said Jay can do it. He can do it. He like, right. Shit. Jay did it. Jay did the tie down and shit like that. He like, shit. I'm about to do my. I'm about to do the Netflix. I'm about to kill Jay.
He got a title. I got Netflix. I got Dash Flicks.
That's what it's called?
I think it's called like Dash Flicks or some shit. Oh,
Dash Flicks. Flick.
I'm just talking shit.
That bitch called
Dash Flicks.
I don't know what it's called. It's but touch. But Dash Flicks, that sound.
We killing nephew Bryant says he ain't quick on his feet no more like I used
to. Nah. It's just I'm trying to live a sober life tonight.
Trying to live a sober life. Nigga, what? You already blow.
Y'all ever seen the Joker though? Before we get out the movies?
The Joker?
No. Yeah, the Joker was straight.
That came out like 2 months
like
ago.
Last year.
Oh, no, I ain't never seen it.
Man, people starting to just catch up on it. Like no, that, I ain't go see it. I just watched it at the crib.
Like the Joker and none of that
the Joker
shit.
Was
I watched
good
it at the crib.
It was good. Look, was look good at look at niggas outside.
I ain't already. Go to sleep on that. That shit was good as fuck.
I got that. Where is that at?
That's at the Staples Center. How they going to have the Grammys, nigga?
That's tonight.
How they going to have the Grammys when they outside like that?
Right.
You
right.
They fucking that shit up. They like
ain't no Grammys.
Yeah, they might have to cancel the. They right. Might fuck around and cancel the Grammys.
I ain't gonna cancel the Grammys, bro.
If all the Kobe Bryant fans just block the street, know what they gonna do?
No whammies.
You right though.
No whammies, dog. Ain't no whammies tonight.
That's right. Yeah.
Only thing we want to see is the Nip tribute.
Mm-hmm.
And we already had one of them anyway. We don't need the Grammys to
validate that. Yeah.
Fuck the whammies. It's National Code Day.
National Code Day, yeah.
Shit, we are 25 minutes in. We ain't got no more time.
We're 2 hours.
2 hours.
25 minutes. 25 minutes. Yeah, 2 hours. Shit, man. I mean, what else we got, man? We about done right now, man. Unless y'all want to snatch somebody, y'all never want to snatch somebody bus, but not today. For the
you're since a pussy.
Mambacast.
You're a pussy.
Nothing.
What? Snatch somebody bus? Who need to get that bus
snatched
this week?
Drummond.
Yeah.
Drummond? We need to snatch Drummond, yeah, man. We need to get him out of here.
Nah, man. We just keep him.
Need to trade him, bro.
He put up like 22 and 21. We lost.
And we still lost.
Right. What else can he do, bro?
Get traded.
You don't take a nigga bus
for putting up. It's like, no, I'm talking shit.
2020.
I ain't going to take his bus. I'm going to take whoever. Who the GM? Who the GM of the Pistons? What's his name? Whoever that nigga man. Is, take that nigga bus.
I say, put that nigga on the Warriors.
That nigga, sure. Man, trade that nigga, man.
Fake.
We so get a boy got his bus snatched.
No, I don't think Drummond got his bus snatched.
No, not Drummond, nigga. He say the GM.
The nigga whoever GM. Made that helicopter, dog.
Whoever.
Nick Cannon got his bus snatched. From
Nick
lying.
Kellen. From Nick lying. Cannon, definitely.
For sure. He was lying.
Yeah, about Orlando Brown.
Yeah, who else? Orlando.
Ain't that his name?
Nick Cannon, you gotta relax. You, this nigga, Nick Cannon, a sick nigga.
Man, he been going crazy in the news lately, man.
Oh, shout out to URL too, man. Smack, all them motherfuckers, they been going crazy.
They need to get like a TV deal.
Hell yeah, man. They been having a lot of good battles releasing and shit. We ain't never talk about that Sue Surf and Geechee Gotti battle. That shit was good as fuck. That shit on YouTube. Nah, niggas gotta watch that shit. That shit good as hell.
And
they just dropped Pat Stay and Shotgun Shug too. That's a good ass battle.
I had to look at that shit.
Yeah, but they been doing some shit, man. They been dropping some good ass battles lately, man. So shout out to them, cause I always be shitting on them niggas when they ain't doing shit. So when the shit going good, Surf about to battle Lux too. Surf about to battle Lux, nigga, soon. So that's the next big shit we gonna. That's the next time I'ma actually cop the pay per view and shit. But other than that, like I say, man, we gonna celebrate Kobe and his family life. Yeah. Shit crazy. Baby was in there.
Yeah, that's messed up, man. Pray for their family, man. Pray for everybody that support him. If anybody he touched lives, you know what I'm saying?
Praying for their family.
Them too, man. You know how some people. Some people take it really, really.
Praying for everybody that was on the plane. You know, so they said it was nine people all together. So
everybody in the plane. They was just parents taking their kids to practice too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's what's crazy about it. That just looked like it's just an open field. You know what I'm saying? So it had to be something wrong. Saying, man, that be making me not want to take. You know what I'm saying? I ain't scared to fly because obviously I'm not. But you just never know.
That made you second think.
But I ain't about to drive to these places that I want to go.
Yeah, you can't drive.
So what I'm supposed to? I can't just sit in there. But this might, you know.
But you got to think about Kobe flying every day. It's like down there.
Everybody felt that one.
You gotta think about it, and yeah, they fly every day. You know what I'm saying? You constantly on a plane. You so used to flying. That was at least his words.
All right. Probably this shit was just a regular. His daughter too. Think about it. His daughter probably been flying on helicopters for a minute. A helicopter is way different than the plane, bro. If you on a helicopter, bro, you gonna be feeling like you right there with the shit. You know what I'm saying? If you in a plane, you gonna feel the shit as long as you don't look out the window. You know what I'm saying? When you landed and taking off.
Helicopter way close to the ground.
Right, it's just way you can.
Helicopter be way close to the ground.
You know what I'm saying? Just be hovering and shit, bro. So, man, that's crazy, bro.
Always keep faith. Never lose hope. Never stop dreaming, baby. Keep that Mamba mentality.
It's been a long day.
Hard work, dedication.
Without you, my friend.
It's always somebody out working harder than you. You can't let these motherfuckers outwork you. You gotta always keep working.
Come a long way.
We ain't gonna stop.
From where we began.
We appreciate everybody that tuned in. Y'all make sure y'all get home safe. Aunties, uncles, nieces, nephews, toes and fuels.
Nephews.
Ball of heaven, Kyle.
All the planes we flew, the things we've been through. Then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got?
R.I.P.
Ashtray, bitch.
Anything I would do, you were standing there by my side.
I had to, though. I couldn't resist. Ball of heaven, Kyle. We celebrate your life, my baby.
You, my friend.
You inspire so many people.
And I'll tell you all
the world wouldn't have been the same without you. Appreciate everything that you done motherfucking contributed to the world.
Where we began.
You know, we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
Tell you.
When I see you again.
What's happening, man? Hey, this TIP, you know. I like to dedicate this song to anybody who done ever lost.
Cause when you die, you just live in the sky, baby. Ain't no such thing as dying. We don't die, we multiply, man.
I feel like the only thing I ain't done yet is die, you know.
Y'all got something y'all wanna say now?
Man, rest in peace to the GOAT. One of the GOATs, my nigga. The Mamba.
Never would have thought waking up today we would all get this news.
Hell no. I don't even think about nothing like that.
Talked about that nigga all last night, though.
Man, I basically been talking about Kobe the last whole week since I've been over on
Kobe. We was in that bitch talking about Kobe. We putting teams together and shit. We was just talking about the best. Like, that shit was wild.
Yeah, about the greatest niggas.
We was watching the game when LeBron passed him and shit.
Mm-hmm. And it happened right before he passed him.
Kobe Bryant.
Kobe Bryant got to, he lived to see that, and then the next day, you know what I'm saying? It's crazy.
Definitely crazy.
I don't even think he was at the game last night. Nah, I don't, was it in LA last night?
Hey,
straight
Kobe,
man, Kobe, bro, that's crazy. Life's ups and downs.
All right, so let out. I'm over in the side.
Hey.
Feels and feels.
Feels and feels, man.
All right, y'all.
Yeah, appreciate y'all, man, for tuning in. Hit the like and subscribe. And rest in peace to the Mamba.
Hey, Bow Wow Brush. Today is Jameson. You
Tyler,
see us.
Tyler Perry, Netflix. Highlight your boy.
Man, we switch
it up. No, not Tyler Perry.
Yeah, Tyler Perry, fuck with me.
Nephew wanna fuck.
I got you for one of the movies, man. I can say ass straight bitch too. Ass straight bitch.
Hold on, show us your acting skills real quick, Neff.
Bitch, you see me? I said with a motherfucking ass straight here, ho.
Told you. Then you gotta say ass straight, bitch.
I see it. Get the ashtray and a glass of Kool-Aid. Immediately.
Immediately. Nah, that's a note. That's a note. Stream for me if you was on there, nephew.
They gonna be like, man, this nigga going nuts. That one nigga.
You wouldn't even say ashtray.
Hey, nephew, I ain't gonna lie though. You could have played the one light skinned nigga that was her nigga, the police nigga. Hey, that don't say shit. That he just kept like this girl get hauled up. Mm-hmm. That could be you.
Hey, it's you,
gonna be you, man.
Tyler Perry was holding her up.
Little Shamar Moore looking ass nigga.
What'd he do?
Shit.
I don't even remember that nigga. What part he do in the movie?
He did. He was the cop. It was you. You know what you did.
The nigga that was a cop to the lawyer.
Look at nephew, man. Hey, that's why he trying to shout that movie out so bad, because he was in it. He was in it. Nah, he like you, nigga.
Stunt double.
Yeah, he was in that bitch.
Nah, shout out to Tyler Perry. Hit your boy.
I just seen him. Oh, lady jump off the roof, baby.
Pop talking. Popovich. Good night, man.
Bang, bang.